making your way in the world today takes everything you've got. Taking a break from all your worries sure would help a lot. Wouldn't you like to get away? Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name, and they're always glad you came. You wanna be where you can see our troubles are all the same. You wanna be where everybody knows your name.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the show. I'm back from my hotel soiree. Check out my background. I've been working hard on this. Can you tell? Dual lighting. We got the red. We got the blue. Or is that teal? I don't know. It's not bisexual. I don't want to hear any of that in the comments. I think it's looking good. And I needed space. I needed space because I've got a Battle Brick Road poster coming and a replicator poster. I'm probably going to get rid of these old Star Wars boxes and put a big replicator right there. Or maybe there. Replicator there, move black and white there. I don't know. We'll see. It's going to look good. I've got some Star Wars Lego. I've got some games. It's all happening. Apparently my team is going to be late today, if they turn up at all. I already see it happening. Amit, no. Absolutely not. If I turn off the red, I just look like I'm in a sea of blue. You know what? Did you respond to that tweet, Rob? Because I don't think I remember seeing Replicator 2 in my list of comics that I've collected links for. So yeah, we might have to search you up manually. Kimosabi, I played it the other day. It's as good as I remember, and my daughter beat me first time. I can't believe it, but I guess she is, it's her age bracket. Let's say hello to everyone. Man, the Bogan Discord's been going off. I mean, seeing there's a bit of a feud starting between Mo Biggs and NTM Comics. But you know, it is what it is. This is the chat is Mo's house, so I guess it's Mo's rules. But let's start saying hello. We've got Skip Edwards here. We've got Mo Biggs. There's NTM Comics. Blue is in the chat, but I think he was doing something. I can't remember what he was doing, but maybe we'll see Blue later. We've got Leroy here. Leroy told me that apparently EVS called Camel Moon Grifter Moon. The meme rises. The fire rises. How good is that? Oh my goodness. Well, he did call me Michael Lucent, so I think it's only fitting. Camel Moon. What are you doing, Moon? Do you want to come and hang out? Let me know, and maybe I'll just send you the link anyway. If I can find you. There you are. Got you there. I don't know what he's doing. But we're gonna go through some comics today. Some campaign pages, sorry. We're gonna check out all the people. We're gonna thank them for fulfilling, for doing what they said they would. Did I say hello to Leroy? Can't remember. Hello, Leroy. Osgreat Sage is here. We got Hockey in the house. Scrolling. Robert Romani. I'm on my desktop computer too now. So I'm not on my little laptop. I can relax. I can sit back. Actually, I'm going to crack open a beer while I'm at it. It's a Peroni. These are Christmas, leftover from Christmas. No VBs today. For some reason, the people, you know, we came over, no one wanted to drink VB over Christmas. I don't know what's going on. I assume you have a stack full of books in your possession that arrived this year to talk about. Yeah, it is absolutely clickbait, but it's got history. I don't know. I mean, obviously I didn't back all of them. I backed a lot though. I have a big, you can't see it, but I got a long box at the top of those shelves, full of CG books. So yeah, it's more of a question out there to the universe, out there to YouTube. Who else is here? Having a look. Scrolling down. Black Rose Comics is here. We got Brian in the house. Kimosabi. How you going, mate? Kimosabi's here. Yes, I am on time again. We're getting into a new... I told you I wanted to see more professionalism. You see, I'm making my background cooler, and that's going to come with it. Johnny Rando, great to see you, my friend. I don't know if I said hello to Amit. Hello, Amit. Nicholas Greer, back again. Thank you. Hello. Seven of Night in the house. Great to see you. Dario Hernandez is here. Jasper Plan 9. There's Rob scrolling down. Who else have we got in here? You have the TMT game. Yeah, man. I went to my mum's at Christmas and just was just like, I can't believe you still got this. It's got my name on it and my old home phone number on it from, you know, early 90s. Just fantastic. K Manifesto's here. Did I say hello to Dario? Hope I did. Edwin's in the house. Who else? Hey, Phil's here. Mike always chooses Camel over me. Well, I didn't see you there, Phil. I'm sorry. Do you want to come in too? I don't know. I mean, maybe you do want to come in. Let me know. We got Lewis here. I always feel weird when I go in a chat and someone invites me on the show. It's like, you know, I'm doing things. Robert's here. Steve's here. Shane. So many people here. It's great to see. We got Hex Allen, Chimera, Professor Murph. I saw him there. My goodness. Flintock. Fields Fulfilled. Hello, Flintock. And great to see you feeling fulfilled. We got Felix Hass, how the sexiest chat in CG, and how you two fellas as well. How you going, guys?
Hey, pretty good. I was just typing into the private chat that I'm going to go get some water. So,
oh, okay.
Cool. How you doing?
Good, good. You like my background there? Everyone's noticing the Turtles game.
It's actually a good game because it's like it's a. Actually, wait a minute. Is it? Is it like a?
It's the one with the little flipper. You got to flip the dice, the die. It's really difficult for an 8 year old. Although my 8 year old kicked my ass at it, so
I could have. I got it confused with at the time they released. I think it was the Colorforms company, and they released like a 3D pop up city. And it's not the game. I thought it was the game, but the city is great because it's good to actually display for your action figures.
I wish I had my action.
Yeah, figures. It's really.
I love those things. But I, like I said, I went to my mum's. I grabbed a bunch of stuff. You can see the extra Star Wars Lego there, that was in boxes, in these boxes, in my old cupboard. I mean, I haven't been back into that wardrobe in 15 years. So it was like I had an extra little Christmas.
You have the OG Star Wars Lego releases too. That's pretty cool. Back when they were all yellow.
The Star Wars what? Oh, right. Okay.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, they used to be yellow. I was I worked at KB Toys where those were released in 99. And we had a midnight release for those.
Look at Leroy trying to get me on track. I do the show at my own pace. Everyone knows that. You get in, you might get anywhere between 5 to 15 minutes of Bancroft Law, and I haven't seen you guys. I didn't see you yesterday. I went out to the hotel. Did you see that photo of me at the hotel?
It's already been
living my best life. It's already been memed. I know.
Did you have some old lady called it in, and the cops are looking for you?
Oh, I was just I didn't plan this. I was just standing like this, and Mel took a photo of me, and my hobbit feet, and there I was, yes, naked under that robe, of course. So how else do you do it? That was straight out of the bath. I don't have a bath here at home, so I was like, I'm taking advantage.
Where are the kids?
And I gave Melbourne a good look at what I'm working with. and everyone cheered and applauded down there. I saw them down on the street singing praises to that weird dude up there. And yeah, it's already been made. There I am. Don't look back. Look, this is Liam's about to look back and see, get a full glimpse. But Kelsey's like, no, son, don't look back. Just keep walking forward to the tower.
Look into the eye. Don't look at Bancroft.
There's her, the culprit. She's the one who took the photo.
I don't know the lore too much of Lord of the Rings, but is there a thing like you're not supposed to look into the eye?
No, never mind.
No, but the Eye of Sauron, when it sees you, you know, it'll come and track you down.
Okay.
Ruin your day.
I saw the movie.
Random crap, homo. Don't worry about it.
Homo Moon. Thank you.
Sorry. First and last name.
About to go full homo. We are one backer away from 666.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Hey, did Ethan call you Grifter Moon today? Was that, did that really happen?
Oh, I don't know. Did he?
That's what Leroy's saying. I've been unplugged. I've been doing family stuff.
I watched Ethan today. I don't think I came up at all. But I don't, you know.
Son of a bitch.
Yeah. I thought they would watch the new episode, but they didn't. He doesn't usually watch the episode when they do, like, news-based stuff. So maybe they'll watch it tonight when they, you know, just kind of chill out with everyone. I don't know.
There he is. He said it. I was there. I mean, I believe you, Leroy, and I love it. It's fantastic.
In what context, I wonder?
It could just be, this is, you know, oh, that new Hail Salad cartoon from Grifter Moon was fantastic. Oh. You know, just like that. Just like, this way he drops it. The way he says, oh, you know, that, you know, Michael Lucent with his animations. You know, he just slides it in there. You don't know how to take it.
I guess. I don't want people to think I'm grifting them, though. I work fucking my ass off on this comic and cartoon.
Maybe if you don't want people to think you're grifting them, maybe you shouldn't go onto people's shows and then just slide out as soon as the second a better offer you know, presents itself.
I don't do that all the time. Just when there's a better offer.
Just on my show, yeah.
I think, hey, I try to give everyone just as much time. There's only so much camel to go around.
Oh, I'm going to leave that one there.
Well, F Google 2 has reminded us, because some of us are purists, thank you, that in Lord of the Rings, you're not supposed to look into the Palantir because Sauron can see you, even though I was just saying random crap. But anyway.
Yeah, they don't know where they all are.
Mm-hmm.
So you know, you never know who's looking, but they know that Sauron and Saruman has one. But anyway, we didn't assemble the people here to talk about the deep Lord of the Rings lore, much as I would love to do that if anyone wants to join me on some of that sometime. We're here because the other day I was watching a stream. It was an entertaining stream. It was a frustrating stream. It was disappointing at some moments. It was funny in other moments. And there were things that were said in it. One thing particularly was said over and over again was COMICSGATE hasn't fulfilled any books in 2020. In fact, I think the words were spoken, where are the books? Where are the books? There aren't any books. There aren't any books. There's only a couple, and I'm holding, and they were holding a couple of them, and then I guess the others, you know, they didn't see them or what, and I thought that was a bit friggin' unfair. I thought that was
A bunch of books came out. Were there like 70 books that came out this year?
Yes.
That was I thought that was, you know, for people who were watching, get the wrong idea.
Did you cry?
I didn't cry, but I just thought that was a bit of a low blow.
I'd respect you more if you'd cried.
Got a lot in 2020. Chimera fulfilled 2. Your boy. I think he's saying that to Chimera. I don't know. But I received a bunch. I got half a long box going. Mm-hmm. And most of it came this year. So I thought what we've done, I know people have been talking about, you know, we've got to talk about the books that aren't fulfilling, because that's a serious thing and that's a big problem. And we can't continue with big books being years late. That's just it's not something that will be sustainable, because, you know, we're trying to keep the audience here, not lose them. Do you agree with that, Joe?
I like your glasses.
Hey, Joe made it.
Is he muted? We can't hear me, Joe. We can hear you. We can hear you. I don't know what happened there. Nice glasses. Weird.
Thanks.
Is that the same hat that says words?
Yeah.
You can put graphics on it as well?
Maybe.
That's rad. Maybe.
Thanks.
You program it. What do you think of my new background, too?
It looks... It's different. Busy.
There's a lot of stuff going on there.
Yeah.
I think it looks cleaner. I like it.
Yeah. I like the two-tone color thing, but more importantly, now I've got space. I can actually put up posters, because I've got two big posters on the way. They could probably go here. And then if someone else brings out a poster, I've got room here.
I didn't realize that was part of a wall. I thought that was a whiteboard or something.
Yeah, that's a wall. That's an empty wall. And that's just boxes I can take off. So
got it.
I've got a two on the way. Let's see who else comes out with a poster worthy of the wall. You could say this is going straight on the wall when it arrives.
Is Brubaker friendly to COMICSGATE?
Is who?
Brubaker.
Jason Brubaker?
Jason Brubaker.
Yeah.
I think so. Yeah.
All right.
He put out a video the other day saying he's just like totally over the BS. He just wants to focus on comics.
Mm-hmm.
He's done with any.
I'm gathering evidence, not making accusations. I don't care.
Yeah. No. And I'm
yes
just
or no. In my own.
He's always been pretty open and friendly. And man, he puts. Talk about a guy who puts out books. He's just got himself a new studio too, so he looks like he's ramping it all up. But anyway, back to the topic. So, yes, you know, discussion needs to be had about unfulfilled books. Here we go. Antoine's just going to speak for me. I think everyone agrees that latent unfulfilled books breaks the CG system. That's why Ethan and a few folks are building private brands anywhere they can control creator output. Look, it is one of the reasons, I suppose, why we do try and stay, you know, independent, but in a group, but independent. That doesn't make any sense with the way I said it, but you know what I mean. Because you can't get tied to, oh, well, this guy, he didn't fulfill in 2 years and he's CG, so now we're going to blame you.
Sort of guilt by association.
Exactly. That can't be the case. But I thought, look, I'm sure there are a lot of books that have fulfilled this year. I know all these people that were saying this on this stream are wrong, or at least they're being flippant or whatever they're being. It wasn't
what stream correct. Is this?
I don't want to say it. But,
okay.
I just thought, look, there's, I think, and on top of that, these people need to be celebrated. These people who did it, they're doing the hard thing. I mean, it's a hard thing to start a book. It's a really hard thing to campaign and then to come through and deliver. That's the business right there. That's what it's all about. So I thought we could just go through some of them. So I sent out a tweet and I said, hey, who's actually fulfilled a book in 2020? Send me the link. And I'm glad I asked for the link, because if people had just replied to me with just the title, that would have been an absolute nightmare. So I could just, you know, click things, and I'm going to just go, these are absolutely no order other than the links that I clicked on the Twitter thread. And, you know, I don't know, look, I did ask, I know in the Twitter thread, I just said which books are fulfilled. I didn't say, is it COMICSGATE, is it not? I didn't really care all that much about that. You know, maybe some of these aren't COMICSGATE, whatever. What do I have to do here? Get rid of this thing. Do not sell my private information. Probably a good idea. I've got it. There's a ton here, and I'm sure we've missed some. But I just thought, you know, hey, let's highlight these guys and, you know, say a little something about them. I still haven't got my lost pages from Phil, but I see it's there. It's out there in the universe. It's out there in the world.
Mm-hmm.
And it's on its way. I don't know exactly when it'll be when it will be arriving, but there you go. Phil Davis. Shane Davis. Love child, Phil. Can you imagine?
Hey, there's Sean Davis. Yeah.
Sean Davis.
I got my shipping codes from him. What do you call them? Tracking numbers. So that one's on the way.
There you go. People are receiving mine as you speak. If they're receiving it right now, they might just sneak into the 2020.
I got mine yesterday. Timeline.
Well, there you go.
You got your Pillow Man?
Yep.
Nice.
I don't think I have Pillow Man on my list, but there you go. Pillow Man. It's in Sydney right now, says Phil.
Mike, I'll get you the link. That's what I'm doing.
Thank you.
I asked if Brubaker was COMICSGATE or just very friendly, because I'm getting you links.
Thank you. I don't like. Look, some of these may or may not align themselves, identify with CG. I mean, I don't really mind all that much, because this is just more a stream about saying, well done, well done,
my
Phil.
Showed up. So I'm happy, Phil, the stuff arrived in nice condition.
Yay. Can I say extra well done for Phil for freaking wrangling 300 people to work on this book?
Yes.
Because anyone who's ever even attempted to get artists and colorists and everyone together to put a book out deserves, you know, that's an achievement in and of itself. So to do an anthology book, he was campaigning this at the same time I was doing mine, and it's already out. So well done, Phil. Fantastic job. Lost Pages. It's still in demand. So there you go. Grab on that. Can't wait for mine. Johnny, is this going to come up every single time?
What?
This stupid thing. Oh, it's because I'm not logged in. Ah, God. Okay. Anyway, moving on. Johnny Phantasm 1977 by our friend Patrick Thomas Parnell. No longer in demand, but fulfilled, and he has moved on to his
glasses.
85, his glasses, his toys. The man's taking it seriously. Great to see. Well done. Well done, Patrick. I'm going to take Blue's link right here. I'm going to copy that link. Copy link address. And I'm going to paste it right over the top of Patrick. So well done, Patrick. They have fulfilled. Pillow Man and Blanket Boy, Maximum Velocity by Sean Davis. Great family man. Made a book with his kid. There he is right there. Co-writer. How cool is that? It's no longer in demand, but maybe Sean will be back with another one. This book looks really good, too.
Mm-hmm. He's definitely working on another book.
Very cool.
Maybe he might give us a hint in the chat what it's about.
Yeah, Sean.
Yeah, Sean. What are you doing?
Why you got to be like that?
No pressure.
Sending
sorry, Sean. Inside Express joke. That's our friend's say. Line. So.
Another book is coming, says Sean. Fantastic to hear. Well done, Sean. Great work. Another man fulfilled. Another book fulfilled. So up to three already. Maybe someone could do a count as we go. Shelby Robertson put out. Now, this isn't a comic book, but it was a sketchbook. And Shelby is new to CG, but I say old to comics. I don't know if that necessarily is a compliment, but veteran, just come on board with CG. He put his sketchbook out this year. There we go, another one in the bank. And he's got a new book up right now, called 94, and lots of things in the work. And he's the inker on Black Flag for our good friend Dan Frager. All right. What the Wizard, also no longer in demand. That was released this year by Mandy Summers. I don't know too much about this book. I didn't really follow Mandy when this campaign was live, I don't think. So, but at any rate, it's there. 345 backers, $22,000, and fulfilled. Another one in the bank. Four. Ha ha ha. I don't know what that is. Vestige one fulfilled. Yeah, there's another one. I don't know if I've got that. I don't know if anyone replied with a Vestige, but yes, I got a Vestige as well. In my long box. Narwhal's Foreign Agent, and this is another one that was happening, I think, at the same time when I was campaigning the Lucent, and here it is already, which is impressive because it's a long book, isn't it? Yeah. It's like 200 pages.
Yeah, I got mine.
Have you read it?
Yep.
I've heard nothing but good things. I've heard nothing but good things. And I don't know why I didn't back this. I just, one of those things I didn't get around to.
Much like Earthbound, it's, when you're reading through it, you almost feel like you're watching animation.
Yeah, well, that's what I exactly found with Earthbound. I had that experience that it was really curious where I was reading, and then did he say that earlier? And I was like, well, I can't stop. I'm going through it now. You know, it's like reading a movie.
Mm-hmm.
It's really, really cool book. I will try and find a place to grab this at some point. Leroy says top CG book, one of the top CG books this year.
I think you can find Foreign Agent, isn't it, in an extra tier in $4.99?
Yes.
Oh, maybe I'll have to do that then. That might be the way, because when this many people are really praising this book, then it's probably going to have to do it.
I posted one for you that I got. I actually got this. It was called Perfect 10.
Yep, I've got that in the list. I've got I see you guys posting links in the background, so thank you for that. And if any of the ones in the list, I've got so many tabs open here.
Oh, okay. No problem.
I'm just closing them off from whatever pops up. Ah, Artsy Bear.
I know why you keep getting that thing at the bottom. It's because you opened them all before answering it once. Yep. So they all have it, but all the new ones you answer should be fine.
Yeah. Well.
Sorry, technical crap. Anyway.
It is what it is. Artsy Bear, Chrono Mechanics. Everyone who's received this, I've seen and really loved it. It's a great looking book. Art had a few issues getting this thing to print, but true professional that he is, he powered through, got it done, and everyone got their Chrono Mechanics in their hands. Congratulations, Artsy Bear. You know, Artsy Bear might be a bit of a double dipper this year. Ooh. In terms of getting books out. So
between that and the first black and white second chance campaign.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I got that too.
Yep.
Yeah. Chrono Mechanics was one of the best looking books that I've seen this year. I'm not saying that because Art's a buddy of mine. It is a gorgeous book.
Oh, I'm so sickened by the fact that he had to get it printed twice and all that other stuff, but it was worth it in the end.
Yeah, I watched his show. I've seen you guys talk about it, and the quality did look amazing. So that really cool that happened. And he did all that while he was selling a house and buying a new house and moving and everything. A best of 2020 list. Oh man, talk about that would. You know, I try to avoid the drama. Patches are awesome. Maybe someone else can do a best of 2020 list. I don't know. Maybe we'll do that. But well done. Well done, Artsy Bear. Another good friend of the channel, Jason Baskin from Unhinged. This is a great-looking book, a great-looking package. I saw a lot of the photos going around of the people getting their packages from Jason. Obviously, you know, he's a really talented artist, and people who got sketch cards and things like that, really, they looked great. In their parcels. So well done, Jason. I don't know how many we're up to now. I'm not counting, but there's a lot. There he is, right there. Artsy Bear, second chance for black and white.
Nice. Is Andy Smith COMICSGATE yet? I know he's coming, but is he there yet?
Because he's not sure who Andy Smith is. I know you've talked about him, but I'm not really down on it. Yes, a true professional like Art wouldn't let moving stop his fulfillment. Grifter Moon wouldn't understand. What do you say to that? What do you say to a man like Mo Binks?
Wait, what did he say? He's
calling you out.
I'm sharpening my knife real fast. What did he say? Okay.
Absolute Chew is right there. You can sign up for the mailing list. So there you go. Here's a man who delivers. And Jason he gets around. We see him a lot in the chat here, but you know, he does his own shows and it's good stuff. Yeah, I didn't get Chrono Mechanics, but I did get Black and White, and it's a fantastic looking book. And there's the poster I got as well. I don't know why Art stopped coming onto the channel to drink with me, because every time he did, I backed him again.
It was that trying to fulfill the book and sell his house and move to the new house and other stuff that was going on. That's all it was. He canceled the weekly Pontificator show several times because there was just too much going on.
Mm-hmm. I hate to be flaky, but I forgot I have pizza rolls in the oven.
Okay, that's cool, man.
Yeah, I'll be back if I can eat them in time.
Yeah. Okay. See you, buddy. See ya.
Flaky Moon every time. The mooching moon, you never know what moon you're gonna get when he jumps in.
Yeah, tonight it was a twofer. First it was Homo Moon and then it was Flaky Moon.
It is what it is. I mean, we can't change a man at his advanced age. Moving on, Elite. Oh, sorry. Oh,
sorry, Mike. I didn't realize you were going to shift over. I was just going to say that Phil Diaz in the chat reminded us that Magic Cop also fulfilled this year. So the Diaz boys are two for two. Magic Cop and Lost Pages.
And I'm going to send him a link because He is not flaky. Phil, when you send him a link, he turns up. He goes the distance. I'm sending him a Pillow Moon link, so I'll probably that's not helpful. But I'll send him the invite to the stream. It's done. Elysian Fields, another friend of the channel, Michael Oden, great dude. And this was his zero issue. So this was like the introduction to his story. The campaign is live right now for the Pyramid Gambit. So that's the active campaign. That's the longer book. But yeah, this came out. He did a cool, like, was it holographic or like it had strange pearlescent gloss on it. It looked pretty cool.
So like UV spot gloss?
No, it was
black print over foil is what it was.
There you go.
Okay. Yeah. Foil. Cool.
Mike, can you move me down so we can actually see Joe?
I'm sorry. Thank you. I haven't streamed for a day. I'm out of practice. I've been having room service and waiting on elevators. My God, it's almost not worth it going out, you know, with the whole COVID things, the masks and everything is separated. We had to stop on nearly every single level to get down, you know, from level 25 down to the ground level because there's only a certain amount of people allowed in the elevator. It was,
wow.
Oh my goodness.
And everybody's waiting. You might as well just
everybody's waiting. Yeah, no, I wasn't going to do that with a three-year-old down 25 flights of stairs.
Carrying a three-year-old. Don't you have a three-year-old backpack?
Yeah, that would be good. Oh, my God. Just pop him on the back. And 28 minutes, 40 more. Thank goodness Leroy's here to keep me on track. Hello, Phil.
Hey, Phil.
Hello, everybody. Hail the chat.
Double fulfillment Phil.
Fulfilled Diaz.
Fulfilled Phil.
Way to go, man.
I like it.
Yeah, it's great to be up here with you guys and be a part of the Fulfilled crew of 2020.
Well, you're making
not people... me. Don't count me in it. I didn't make it. So I have failed. But it will be early 2021. So, you know, snuck it in there.
Well, Phil has made people happy twice, Mike. So you're covered. At least until 2021.
Yeah. Okay, moving on. Well done, Michael. Hybrids, Son of the Gods.
Multiple campaigns fulfilled.
Multiple?
Yeah.
What were the other campaigns?
Up through issue, he got early issues and then up through issue 4 fulfilled and then issue 5 fulfilled. And now the trade paperback has come out and has arrived.
And Luke Stone is one of these creators, and Phil and Brandon are others, so I want to give them a shout-out here, too. I really appreciate when I back a campaign that has been in demand for a while, and the project owners fulfill that order quickly. They don't sit on it for weeks or months. They get the order in, they process it, they ship it out. So kudos to Luke Stone and the Diaz brothers.
Hell, brother.
Yeah, well done, Luke. It's still in demand, too, if anyone wants to pick it up. And now I've got a sinking feeling that I woke up at some point in the middle of the night and read a message from Luke who wanted to come back on the show, and I might have just ghosted him. I apologize if I actually did that, Luke.
No.
Sometimes I read a lot of messages at the wrong hour, and I'm not really have the heart to get back to people. And then they get lost in the ether. But well done, Luke. We'll get Luke back on at some point. Hex Allen, $5. How ComicsGate? Back any Nephilim Squadron tier on Indiegogo during this stream, and I'll throw in a free character sketch of your choice. Very generous, Hex. Thank you very much. That's very cool of you. So, yeah, if anyone has a link there to Nephilim Squadron, that would be cool. There we go. Of course, Felix is on it. Bang.
Thank you, Felix.
Like that. There you go. So go check out Nephilim Squadron by Hex Allen. Great guy in the chat there. So yeah, well done. Well done, Luke. Another great guy who I may or may not have ghosted. I hope I didn't, but you know, things happen. I don't mean to ghost people. I just get busy.
You're just really good at it.
I know. It's a skill. If you're good at something,
Cut the man a break, guys. He lives on the other side of the planet. Come on now.
That's true. That's true.
Actually, Mike, you do sound a bit tired today.
It's weird when, even if it's just a one day thing, it's weird. You know,
when you've got young kids, a vacation is not actually a vacation.
Mm-hmm. Well, like, we were about to go to the pool. Clark was so happy. He was so excited. And all Victoria did was mention, oh, maybe they have balls at the pool. And I reminded her, no, they don't have balls at the pool. Oh, my goodness. 20 minutes of bawling from Clark. So he's gone from really, really happy to just being, I want a ball. Tears down his face. And you're just sitting there like, what can you do?
It makes you wonder, who's giving my children cocaine? Who is doing that?
Leroy's calling me out. I don't even know. We don't really have a timeline on this anyway, so because I'm not working today, so we can just get back to it, get through it. USA Assassin Book 2. We've had Mark on the show. He was a great guest. This is a really cool looking book. I didn't back it, so I didn't see the actual physical thing, but man, the art looks great. I got the one that came free with Graveyard Shift.
Yeah, that was super fun. Recently backed this, and the next day I got tracking for it, and it's on its way right now. So he's another guy, like Joe was talking about, someone that is constantly fulfilling even when he's in demand. And, you know, they're talking about the third one. I think the interiors are already done for book three, I should say. So that's what really sold me on getting this one right now, because I saw some stuff coming up in number three and I'm like, oh, that's awesome. I gotta
back this one. Way to go, Mark and Mike. For anybody who hasn't heard of this book yet, it's kind of like a cross between G.I. Joe meets American Ninja.
Yep. It's awesome. And the villains, if you guys haven't read the first book, you probably got it with Graveyard Shift 2 if you backed that. Definitely give that a read, because the villains in it are just a band, motley crew of themselves. You know, they're really cool designs for bad guys.
There you go. One and two fulfilled. Fantastic. Mm-hmm. Great to see. Top guy. Grim Reaper 2. John and Carla, everyone's favorite CG power couple. Yeah. Great people. This is a great looking book. Carla's just really come into her own, you know, even while she was, dealing with, you know, being pregnant and John having to deal with the world, you know, that seems to affect him greatly. They're just going up in leaps and bounds, and they got this one out. I know Carla's working on a bunch of other stuff as well, so... Really,
you have to remember about this one too, is their like apartment burned down when they were working on this, and they lost a lot of stuff. Yep. So these guys pulled it together and fulfilled through that as well.
Yep. Sorry, I don't mean to laugh at that. I'm laughing at Snuggy Jr.'s comment. Remember, everyone, Mitch fulfilled and Walmart.
Those smiley faces. Oh, great. Did that final part of Red Rooster show up in Walmart? Because I haven't gotten my.
I don't think it did. If it did, we would have gotten the emails. I get a ton of emails from them.
If Red Rooster didn't finish at Walmart, the Allegiance Comics 3-pack did. So yay.
Thank you, Snuggy Jr. Well done. Well done, John and Carla. Great stuff. Grim Reaper 2 in hands. This one I'm not familiar with, but someone posted the link to it, so I thought I would chuck it up there. I do recognize Lewis Michael on Twitter, but I don't know too much about this book or who he is.
It looks hilarious. I hope it's actually good. I mean, it looks like just this big, silly book, so I hope it's actually good so I can review it.
Yeah, I remember this was from a while back. Yeah. I think they were promoting when we were promoting Magic Cop 1, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, this one, he ran into a bunch of trouble and felt really bad and, you know, was like, I'm powering through, guys. And then finally it showed up. And it's huge format, too. It's one of those European larger formats.
Mm.
I really dig this art. When you say European, it's got that European vibe in the art as well. Very cool. There you go.
And of course, everything's orange, so I got to go get a second copy for Liam.
Yeah. Mandatory. Lewis Michael, Chromosome 96 issues 1, 2, and 3. There you go. They came out. They were fulfilled in 2020. Blood Hunt. Payback is a something. It's censored. Uh-oh. I can't figure out what that is. So I'm just gonna have to skip on that. But that's from our boy Simon Potier.
Yeah, I just that was great. Yeah, this is an awesome nonstop action book. You know, Sim is one of the artists in CJ that has such a distinct style. He built his rapport doing fan art for like every CG comic for the first, you know, 2 years. And you could see he has a distinct style. You see in everything he does, and he loves the boobs and blood in this one. It's about a vampire assassin, or an assassin that is bitten by a vampire and now has to deal with himself being the monster and hunting down those that turned him as revenge. So really fun, action-packed. There's a lot of cool Easter eggs and homages to CG in the background. Sim loves throwing that into his books. So yeah, this one was a lot of fun. And I think you could still get this through his new campaign for his new book, which is Tales from the Gnatverse. So I think there's a tier where you can get Blood Hunt with that too. So if you missed out.
A Chimera pointed out that you're far better than I am at promoting these books. Hey there, Sim. He's giving us some of these.
Hey, Sim.
What's up, Sim?
And a lot of people, yeah, psyched for this one. Crackhead says, yeah, saw his fan art everywhere. Dude's got skills.
Yeah.
Bandito's here.
The cool thing about this one as well is he did a sketch card for every backer.
I remember that. Yeah. I remember that. And they weren't just like the same card over again. He was going all in. It was crazy. But anyone who's ever streamed with Sim, you know, anytime you're seeing, what's going on? What are you up to? I'm drawing.
Dude. He does not sleep.
He can draw and talk. He has no problem with that.
And anybody who backs Sim's books, when he offers you a sketch card, you're going to get an original piece of work. Like Phil said, he's not doing, you know, the same sketch 100 times. You're going to get a like unique that. Piece of art, and it's going to be at a great price.
Rob points out 76 backers on the campaign, 213 while in demand. And you can see it's not like he's been in demand up until now, you know. That's a major hustle. So well done, Sim.
Mike, can you enlarge Phil for a second?
Oh, sorry, Mike,
showing off the little original art.
Yeah, so here's the book, and then here's the little sketch card that came with.
And there it comes in a friggin' like top plastic, loader.
It came with a card top loader. Yeah.
Yeah.
Really cool. So yeah, badass book.
Yeah, speaking of Chimera, SOS Onslaught graphic novel, the first one. So Chimera's got the second one. The campaign is out there now, but this is the first one, and this was delivered. Well done, Chimera.
Yeah, Chimera's a couple times. Yeah, he's another guy that doesn't mess around. He gets his campaigns done, he fulfills them, and he's on to the next book. Not a lot of I don't know, I guess what you would say hype surrounding the guy, but it's
Chimera knows, and Deadwood Dale called him out the other day on his video saying Chimera is vicious in the chat.
Oh yeah, for sure.
but on the stream he's a man of very few words. No, that's the spin-off. Volume 1 was the first one. Okay. Sorry.
Yeah. I've seen Chimera around, and then through buddies like Adam AF and guys that backed the first book, they're like, this is a funny ass book, man, and everybody needs to read it. So I saw this Bisley cover and I'm like, fuck, I got to get the Simon Bisley cover.
The Bisley man.
And read both of them, and Chimera is one of my favorite writers in CG. This series is high up there, if not the top for me. He knows how to write funny scenes. It's like watching the comedy in here is like watching an Adult Swim cartoon, and he's not afraid of taking a page just for a joke. And that's something for, as a writer, I think comedy's hard to write for me. And I, you know, look to him for that stuff, because that is really, give him props for that, because it's awesome. So nice. That series is so badass. Really good. Excited for the new one too.
Are they linked to Chimera's current campaigns in the chat? And Sim put up there that if anybody backs his current campaign, yeah, they get a sketch card tonight. I don't know how he's getting you the card tonight.
Wow. And Chimera's saying that on his Volume 2 campaign, both those books that Phil showed will also be available. So you can get in on all three if you've missed out.
Nice.
Okay.
Hi, Greg.
Well done, Chimera. Ironsight's Two Psychos, second printing. Is that like a second chance thing? I don't know if this was like I don't know. I didn't back Ironsight, so.
Yeah, I think that's a second chance thingy.
Okay. Hello. I don't want to get struck. your boy Zach he's been a bit of a on a fulfillment craze this year, I think. I think he's in here a bunch of times. So there's the second print. I don't know, if that's, like you said, if that's the second printing, then I guess that's just a matter of supply and demand. But still, another book out. I'm in Ironsights 2, 7 and 9. Yeah, what books aren't you in?
This guy's like the Chris Evans of CGs in every book.
Apparently we should not forget Rockabilly Road Trip. I don't know if I have Six Gun Gorilla on this list either.
Links I dropped you. I started loading them in my own window to share, because you trying to load
even them better. Even better.
I got you.
Okay. City of Venus, Dead City. By our boy Vincenzo Tatamella.
I think I got that in 2019, and I still haven't read it.
So, well,
I thought it was still a 2019 book, but I mean...
Okay. Then screw it. We close it.
Take it off.
Through the Woods, hardcover, collected edition. This is on my shelf. Where is it? There it is, up there. I don't know if you can see it because of my big head or whatever, but it's there. Great looking book. And Vinny is actually launching a pirate book, Kraken book. He's releasing the Kraken in 4 or 5 days.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So Vinny gets around and he calls himself, I don't know if he calls himself it or other people call him the fulfillment king, but he's looks like he's earned it, man. He gets out there. I think he fulfilled 7 books in 1 year at some point.
Yeah, he's another guy that even if you find his books in demand, you place that order, he processes it quick and sends it right out.
Jasper looks forward to that when everyone is doing second printings. Absolutely. Oh, to have that kind of demand where you don't have to actually do any work. You just have to send it back to the printer and make money.
That's the dream.
That's the dream, exactly. He's best known as the Boner King, but that's true. Also the Fulfillment King. Fair enough. Good point. Professor Murph. Yeah, we can. It's optional. It is optional, but you're probably better off if you do.
Personally, I like to read the books. Even Vinny's. They look even gorgeous, Vinny's. But I do like to read the words as well.
Yeah, I would appreciate it. I did a stream with Sweens talking about the Lost Pages right when he got it. Mm-hmm. And then like halfway through the stream, I found out he didn't even read it. He just looked at the art. And he was also really drunk as well. It was a great stream. You can check it out on Zate Comics. He loved how it felt as well.
Being an artist, I do have a list of books that I've received, but haven't read yet. And you know, I will get to them, but, in due time. But this isn't one of them. I read Through the Woods, really cool book. Beautiful art. And well done, Vinny. And I'm really looking forward to your pirate book.
Phil, did you say that Drunk Vinny was on your channel?
I'm sorry, what's that?
What channel is Drunk Vinny on? I gotta see that.
Yeah, it was Drunk Sweens.
Drunk Sweens. Sorry, I'm multitasking badly. Anyway,
I apologize, Professor Murph, for not lingering on the booty. There's some Kelsey Shannon booty. There's some Vinny booty. There's some more Vinny booty. Is that?
Wait, go back to that first Vinny booty you showed. There we go. No, down a little. Sorry,
Oh, yeah. I know what you're looking at. That bear. Yeah. I know.
I was there when this was the photo was
you
taken.
You were there. You were looking at the popcorn, though. Always thinking of food, bloke.
I got a beautiful lady and a bowl of popcorn. I'm happy. It's all I need.
Exactly. AATD. Exactly. All right. Well done, Vinny. Step one by Nathan Rosario. This guy kind of came in. He was a bit reticent to get on the streams, but it's a cool looking book. The book came out. And
his ISP really sucks.
Okay. It's this dude who looks like he should be playing rugby. For anyone who knows what rugby is, and there's robots, and yeah, it's good art. I don't know anything about the story, but did you do a review of this one yet?
Yeah, I tried to film my review twice yesterday, and
that one.
It took too long because there's so many good things to say about it.
Oh, great!
Trying to shorten it up.
That's
very
good.
Cool to hear. He's smashing this thing.
Really
teeth.
Cool action.
Yeah, it's just really nice, tight pencils and good looking book. Stump. Maybe next time Nathan will get out there. But man, he got 244 backers. Oh, this was the cheapest book out. It was the $5 comic book. So yeah, there you go. I mean, it can be done.
This was one of the sleeper hits of 2020.
Yeah, he was expanding this book from 22 pages, I think. I'm guessing because he said over 20 extra pages. It was supposed to be 32. It ended up 48 for $5.
For $5?
Yeah. This is the second time he published it. So
Jesus. Yeah. That's crazy.
Rob is wondering if the people I referred to at the top of the stream didn't actually back any books then complain they didn't get any. I don't know. It kind of felt like that to me, which is why I was a bit like, that ain't right, but I don't know. Maybe. People get in bubbles and they think, well, if I'm not getting books, no one else is. Clearly, a lot of people were. Welcome back.
I'm full now.
How are you? You're all good?
Yeah. I was hungry. I was getting cranky.
I mean, on every other night. On every other night, he's full of crap, but tonight he's full of pizza rolls.
My wife was like, I'm going to make you some pizza rolls before you go to bed. I was like, and then I forgot they're in the oven.
What's a pizza roll? Is that?
It's the grossest thing in the world. It's a little.
It's something soccer moms make for their 12-year-old children.
I don't think we have pizza rolls here. If we do, I never got them.
They're like tiny little egg rolls, but for like pizza.
Imagine a miniature bed pillow that looks like fried bread filled with pizza stuff.
Dumpling with tomato sauce.
It's like leftover, like all the shit that's left on the floor at Domino's Pizza. They just scoop it together and they make little wontons out of it.
You're not selling them to me.
I'm not trying to.
Okay.
7 of 9 says they're Satan's boogers.
and Greg says dog food for humans. Do you have heartburn?
Didn't you just eat escargot or some shit the other night before you?
Yeah,
tried to
try to mix it up.
Sometimes I love escargot. Sometimes I'm elevated. Is a delicacy.
Sometimes I need to kind of bring it down to the plebeian level.
You have triggered the chat with your pizza roll talk. Except Steve. Steve's on board. Steve's like, send me some if you don't want them.
Hey, like they're disgusting, but they're good. Like if I made you a bunch, you'd be like, I can't believe I keep eating these.
Maybe we do, Edwin, but I just didn't get into them. Hockey reckons we do have them, but I don't know. There's whole areas of the supermarket that I don't really go down. All right. Now, this was the link sent to me. I know everyone's saying, oh, shit, Billy's not CG. Well, he promotes to CG, and this was a great campaign. Look, there we go. We're talking fulfillment today. This was a great package to receive. There was lots of cool stuff in there. Great looking book.
Absolutely gorgeous.
And I friggin' missed out on the second one because I didn't know what did he do? Like a 32 campaign? And then he
went over to Kickstarter, which I was surprised to see because I thought he was saying that after doing Return of the Warrior, Kickstarter just, it wasn't worth it. The return on investment wasn't enough. So I thought he said that the next one, Haikyo, was going to be Indiegogo exclusive.
And he, did he do a Kickstarter for Haikyo?
Yeah. Well, he just started one.
Oh, wow. I didn't know that.
Or at least announced it. I saw the Pop XP show notification. I think it was yesterday. I haven't gotten a chance to check it out, but I thought they were announcing they were going to Kickstarter.
Yeah. Look, yeah, I'm exactly with Jasper right here. I mean, I don't care about what anyone says. Billy is the boss, and man, does he put out a good looking book. And he's a baller on Twitter too. Did you see that tweet he sent? Merry Christmas and fuck him.
Yeah.
Billy's awesome. He was in Chicago before we launched Magic Cop, and I met him there, hung out with him the whole day and just hit it off. And the guy gave me his cookie from the DoubleTree Hotel.
So. Oh, stop name dropping, Phil. Fucking not awesome. All of us can just go hang out at conventions with all these people.
Right? I gotta say, with Billy, it's kind of surreal. I was working in a comic shop in 1994 when she first launched with Lady Death. And to be around 25 years later when he launches Return of the Warrior himself, independent, and then to see the follow-up success is just awesome.
Yeah.
Jim says the second one is still... It is. It was closed. I went to it. It was closed.
Well, Haikyo?
I went to this a week ago. It was closed.
Maybe they forgot to push it.
All right, well, I will back it then.
He put it back, yeah.
Okay, so he's put it back.
Yeah. They might have forgot to push the demand.
Yeah.
Yeah, we talked about it on Shane's stream.
Okay, cool. All right, well, there you go. Here you go. I mean, Billy's a legend and obviously the man...
Yeah, he's rock and roll. He's a pillar of the comics collective, man.
Oh, what's this?
Speaking of pillars of the comics collective.
Speaking of pillars, we got Magic Ones as well.
Yeah, Magic Con, man.
The first book that we're aware of in crowdfunding to give you the soft Diaz touch.
That's right, brother. And, you know, you'll see it now, books that are coming out, they're copying us. And
I'm hearing about it. People are talking about it. But
they ask, and they're like, what's that? You know, and I tell them, but I'm like, it's kind of a Zade Comics special, you know. But, you know, whatever gets the sales, people love the soft touch of the Zade brothers. So, yeah.
You mean that wax film that goes over the cover?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like a velvet. It's like a velvet finish, and Magic Cop was the first one, and it's to replicate what Phil's hands feel like under his glove.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah. For sure. This was our first thing. It was 92 pages. It was a big comic, and you know, the first time ever doing crowdfunding. My brother did all the art. It took us like 6 months to get it out, but. But we did. We shipped on time, and we're doing Magic Cop 2 now. But yeah, this was a lot of fun for us. An IP we're going to be doing for a long while. Very different than the Lost Pages. It's a good mix of pacing, I think. As creative.
Excellent. Well done. Double dip, Diaz. Full-filled Diaz. Yeah. I love it. Excellent. Back these guys with full confidence. Great job.
Thank you so much.
Another one I just clicked. I know nothing about it. Holger the Last Viking. Does anyone know this?
I seen it recently. I didn't know that. I figured this came out or just launched because I had only seen it probably the last 3 months, but
well, it's closed. Yeah. It closed in August 31st. I mean, someone is alleging that it has been
it is fulfilled.
Okay, wow, there you go. That's crazy.
Yeah, well done. Honors too.
Shay, what's her name? Shay Red Valkyrie pushed it really close to the end of the campaign, and yeah, he fulfilled.
Well done. Michael Anden I haven't seen Michael in a while, but
same.
Well done. Well done.
Yeah,
buddy, fulfilling model worlds.
This book. They've just been shipping out. People have been getting them. Yeah, really cool book. I had him on promoting on my channel. Actually, it's funny. Something came up and he missed the show, but I went through the campaign anyways, and it got backers, which was really cool, even though he wasn't there. But yeah, this one was very much like Kirby-esque, even like a little kind of reminds me of some Mobius stuff.
It's its own thing, isn't it? Yeah. I mean, surely he, you know, he draws inspiration from a bunch of different people, but you can't really look at this and say this is anything but Michael Andon. It's his own thing. It's really cool, and I'm really happy to hear.
It reminds me of some 90s space arcade games. Like, there's a game called Forgotten Worlds that looks.
There you go. Sim's got it. David's got it. Michael Andon was Moe's only sub. Oh no!
Damn.
He lost him. Apparently, it's a large format. I didn't know that.
It's European also.
Yeah.
So is the Ash
Kamek. 2000 AD. All right. Didn't the Andons have a bit of a row with Ethan? I got no idea. I don't follow the rows of
if this sounds
different people.
If this sounds familiar, then you'll know the Andons. Ethan Van Sciver! But they patched things up and it was all good after that.
Okay.
Man, that's a throwback.
So many things I miss. Got some Duke Nukem vibes. Yeah, it does, doesn't it? I don't think Comicsgate didn't fulfill at all this. I'm starting to get that vibe as well, Captain Biggins.
I'm sure there's
to get that vibe. Yeah, there's some big campaigns that didn't fulfill, that won't fulfill in 2020, even though you know, people promised that they would. But, I mean, there's plenty that have. More Lethal by Alan Calamari. Another one. Mm-hmm. Again, I'm just clicking links. I don't know this book. But it looks like it's from King Toad Comics. And we know them.
Yeah, this is the first book that has the King Toad kind of like publication stamped onto it. This is a book done by Aaron Calamari, who is a awesome creator. He did a book called Cybershock as well. He's really good at writing high-paced action. If you love action comics, that's what Aaron does. You slice and dice, and this one's a slice and dice comic. You got Canalis on art, Aaron writing. It's a very kind of like cyberpunk ninja style. The books he's doing currently have that cyberpunk feel. And it has a very interesting kind of like video game-esque twist on it. It's in manga size format as well. I think it was a digest, they call it. And it also did come with a pinup from my brother. My brother did a pinup poster for this campaign, which is pretty badass.
Robert is confirming he has gotten it. I'm happy to hear. I saw it somewhere. Mo did get a new sub. So well done, Mo, and it's a better sub even. So I'm very happy to hear that from Mo. There you go.
It is cute sized. Lethal. So,
yeah, very cute sized.
Niobe, Larry Higgins. Does anyone know about this one?
No, Niobe? Didn't even know the guy was Comicsgate friendly.
I got no idea. Sure people are sending me links.
Yeah,
he hates that name.
Comicsgate.
Yeah. He's a Canadian. He's CG friendly.
I didn't recognize the name until I saw the boobs on the motorcycle.
We got Rags in the background too, doing some Rags collabs. Yeah, this
looks good. I don't know anything about it. So
I've never read it. I know the only thing I know about this is he gets a lot of different artists to do like cool pinups in Niobe. You know, very. Badass babe book. I think she could make portals and go through them kind of like Blink from X-Men.
Mm.
Anton wants to know, has anyone ever seen the other Diaz brother? I've seen him in a car.
I have, but quite frankly, it might have been a cardboard cutout. I'm not sure.
Mm.
Mm-hmm. He exists. You guys will see him once we start promoting Magic Up 2 more. For the first book, he was on a lot with me, but he's been drawing Magic Up 2 while I've been kind of promoting the Lost Pages. So I keep him chained in his room.
Drawing. These artists, I tell you what. All right, moving on. Hey, Red Eyes, Episode 1 by David Feed.
Yep.
And this was potentially the first book to use the, or one of the first to use John Malin's fulfillment service.
Really?
Yeah. I've seen photos of people with their parcels, and people seem happy.
Very cool.
The book looks great.
Well done, David Feed.
And that we all know David. There he is right there.
It just arrived, just making it in the timeline, you know, in the deadline for 2020.
Yeah, that's
seven
great.
Seven of Nine has a theory as to why we don't see Brandon. I think he might be on.
Man, there's some people think that's true, but not everybody could be right. You know what I'm saying?
I did a pin up for Red Eyes 2. Check it out on David's free Twitter. Yeah, so Red Eyes 2 is it's live. We've had David on here to chat about it. So here's a man who gets his books out to you. Another one. Bancroft may be CG, but he ain't all that friendly. Well, that's depends on who it is, Skip.
True.
Don't think I didn't see you earlier calling out my posting that video on my channel. I was in that video just as much as you were. I have every right to post that video on my channel. And Merry Christmas, Skip. I hope you're using that tool set to its full capacity in as much as is possible, considering the tools that you received. Kino Subway is still waiting on his. It's on its way, though. Yeah, we do have to, unfortunately, go through that, but hopefully it turns up soon. Oh, and Greg says he never sees Brandon and Lobo in the same place. That's that theory is a bit more off the wall. I don't know about that.
Yeah, one. I take offense to that.
Mike, I'm making a window to share when you're done with your list. I've got 31 more campaigns.
I see the one. The first one you've got in your list, I've got it. but it's all good. We can just close them if we double dip. That's all right. Adventures of Kim Il-sung or Sung and Best Korea by our friend Commie Mark. This one went out. Everyone saw it because people were getting that foil variant, which was really right hilarious. Here.
Yeah, Phil's got the not chromium.
Oh, he's got it. The not foil variant, sorry.
Ooh, that's fancy.
Not chromium.
Not chromium cover, as you could see. Great propaganda comic.
Yeah.
Very funny. And really excited to see the next books that Commie Mark comes out with. He's got a lot of cool stuff in the works.
Yeah, his next one is called Krishna Kid.
Yeah.
And he might have a mailing
as well.
Oh yeah, you're right, Mike. Thank you for the clarification there. That not Daredevil. And then I think he's got the mailing list for Krishna Kid. Is that right? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We're going too slow for Rob, apparently.
Jesus.
Sorry, Rob. I mean,
We
may or may not have time to get to Replicator.
Well, he's anxious for us to brag about his fulfillment of Roblocopter Relubricated. So there they are.
Jesus. Great subtitle.
I love it. Krishna Kid. Although some people were saying to him he should call it Kid Krishna. I don't know which one's better.
I like Krishna Kid.
But anyway, that's up to him. All right, moving on. Inglewood by Micah Curtis. Micah has this book. He's got Three Nights, Four Days, which I don't think is fulfilled yet. And he's also doing some work. This is all going off memory with Peregrine, maybe a side story or something like that. And I know he's got plans for more of this stuff in the future. So well done. Congratulations, Micah.
Based in Chicago.
Getting his first book out.
Inglewood's always up to no good.
Inglewood. Then Elwood as well is a place, isn't it? Elwood.
Elwood.
Elwood? Isn't that a suburb? I don't know. Maybe I'm getting confused with Englewood. But anyway, okay. There we go. Well done, Michael Curtis. He was there. He stepped away from 1 second. I was waiting for. I was just like buying time because I knew you were in the chat. And I'm like, there you go. Yeah. Congrats, man. Good job. Anyone who fulfills definitely deserves a tip of the hat. Is Bancroft thinking of the Blues Brothers? I don't know.
yeah. You're right.
Could be the Blues Brothers. Here we go. This is why I was waiting for a little bit of information. We're starting on production of Englewood Book 2 next weekish.
I saw that. Yeah, there was a tweet. I think I saw that today. Tweeted out. January starts the production.
Good to hear. 543 backers, which is pretty amazing for a first book.
Oh yeah.
All right. Here's one that people were talking about in the chat. Perfect 10. Now I've heard fantastic things about this book. I was not aware of it while it was happening, but I've heard really good things. I don't know if any of you guys have got it.
I got it. I got it too. Yeah.
This is actually a book that my non-existent brother backed, and he read it. He said it was awesome, and then he gave it to me to read, and then I never got around to reading it.
But we're talking about Chimera. And there we go. You're holding it up. She's more like a six.
No, she's pretty high.
Why isn't Chimera like this when he's on the stream? He's just like, he should actually just chat in the chat while he's on the stream.
But
that Chimera is not impressed.
He might be a fan of long hair ladies. He might bump up that score.
Fair enough. Yeah, fair enough.
She had the long hair. Like Phil.
Yeah,
Phil, be careful.
We've not gone to Seven Legions yet, but I do believe it is on the list. Michael, thank you for joining us. Kimasabi says, watch his review. What did you think, Kimasabi? Was it a perfect 10? David Feed got it as well. There it is. All right. Fenrir Fire, I got perfect 10, fun read. Great to hear. Well, there you go. It's a really good looking book. Oh, maybe I shouldn't scroll down. I don't know what's down there. Hold on.
Yeah. Definitely a
really good looking book.
But, there you go. Kimasabi says it was. I literally named the review video that. Yeah, well, there you go. I've heard really good stuff about this book, so. Perfect 10 by Dave Brink. Dave is doing. He's been on Twitter talking about his new book. I can't remember what it's called. Maybe someone in the chat will know. But it looks cool. Yeah, but you know, YouTube is YouTube. So I don't know if I want to post it. But yeah, anyway, Dave, well done, excellent job.
There's a lot of smoke and fog as bikini in those promos, if I remember.
He's working on his new book, Perfect 11. Yeah, you've got to have smoke, mist, bubbles, whatever you can to get past through the senses. Matt Krotz, again, like, I don't think this guy identifies as CG, but he's definitely hangs around. I see him on Twitter. I see him in chat sometimes. The book looks really good. And I think he's on his third volume right now.
Very fancy looking.
I love the style. I love the topic. I haven't backed this. I haven't read it, but I've heard great things. The guy seems really cool. So I thought
we
would.
The art style reminds me of French comics for some reason.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. It's funny how I'm drawn to this kind of thing. You could see it as kind of like a really top quality children's book illustration.
Yep.
But it really fits this subject. So I probably will end up backing this one at some point because I like the subject matter. The guy seems cool and the art seems
Well,
really
you'll probably
really
get
good.
It quick. I think he already delivered mine.
Oh, there you go. You haven't read it yet?
Correct. I've read volume one. I reviewed it, but I haven't read volume two.
Okay. There you go. Whoa, what is this? Seven Legions. I clicked a link and it takes me to sevenlegions.com.
Website.
Websites. What did it do? Websites.
There we go.
Well, special like that. Well, good job on the website. Seven Legions. Fulfilled. There you go, Michael.
Fulfilled, and he's still fulfilling. So if you're back, he's been sending out the books. And the cool thing, too, is he and... Sometimes I hop on to Sim's channel to do Doodle and Chill,
and they'll draw things, you know, whatever the topic is. And then he says whoever backs the next backers of Cyber Legions, he sends his original art from Doodle and Chill over there in the package. Nice.
Another favorite of Sims.
Cool, epic space science fiction. You got some awesome Pablo Romero art as well in there. Michael colors the whole thing himself and writes it.
Yeah, Michael's, I've hung out with him a couple of times. I was on a stream not that long ago. It was three or four of us named Michael.
Yeah, that's why I call him the beak. You know,
there he is, the beak. He's thanking Dario. Yeah, yeah, looks really good, man. Congratulations. Poor Leroy's all tuckered out. He's going to go to bed. He's been out shopping with his missus today. Thank you for hanging out, Leroy.
Yeah, Leroy.
And Michael, it's cool to see the creators actually in the chat as we're talking about the book. That's really, really cool to see. Rob's calling out Leroy. Don't pussy out. You stick in here with us. We go through to the end. All right. Well done. Well done, Michael. Looking forward to what you got coming next. Eudaimonia 2 from Tanda. This is one I have got, and this is on my list yet to read. Book looks great. I haven't read it yet, but I've heard really good things. It's obviously it's quite different style of book, both in art and writing. It's written in whatever that thing is.
Iambic pentameter.
There you go. I already embarrassed myself by being unable to pronounce subterfuge. basically, I wasn't going to try that.
Shakespeare rhyming.
Yep.
Yeah, I got volume one and loved it. Somehow missed volume two, so I'm hoping I can pick it up.
Rob liked it better when I was unpopular. I'm sorry, Rob. I'm learning to give the people what they want. I make my background all flashy for them.
Sounds like the Robocopter's peanut butter and jelly.
It's crazy, isn't it, Kino? People, you know, people aren't there saying Comicsgate didn't fulfill any books in 2020. I think we're proving them wrong. We look at how many tabs I still have left open. So well done, Joshua. Joshua's another guy. I worry. I think I may have ghosted him. I think he's reached out to me and I haven't gotten back to him yet. So we'll try and get Joshua on.
Wow.
Talk about the book. I know I'm terrible. I really am. But
I'm sorry. What was the point of saying, whoever said it, that there was no books that were fulfilled this year?
You're really trying to pull this out of me, aren't you?
No, we're doing a stream, right? The stream is to prove whatever. I don't know. I genuinely don't know.
It was one of the reasons given as to why Comicsgate is dead. There were many reasons given as to why Comicsgate is dead.
Leroy did that phase stream this past week, right? You're on there, Michael, even though you're a creator and it was the chat stream. But
I have special privileges.
Yeah. So, but they were, you guys were putting together the unfulfilled campaigns list, basically. And those stick out so much because they're grossed huge amounts of success, right?
It's a big problem. It's
right.
They probably can't afford to ignore.
But so I think when a lot of people look at CG as a whole, I think there's a lot of people that don't see smaller campaigns that are fulfilling because there's so much spotlight on these big campaigns. So when they don't fulfill, it sticks out like a sore thumb. And people could, you know, pass on the misinformation that CG is not fulfilling because there's hundreds of thousands
people
of
saying this person was only looking at the big campaigns. I have that feeling, but it wasn't one person. It was actually mentioned by a bunch of different people in that stream. So that's why. So I think it was just like, I think it is, you know, people just not noticing all the, you know, all the other stuff going on out there. What big campaigns didn't fulfill? Well, there's a bunch. I mean, holding over, but also there's been ones that were said they were going to fulfill by Christmas this year and haven't. Stuff like that.
Or Christmas last year.
Leo, I think, is actually going to dive into that on his next chat. He's going to talk about, exciting. You know, like, because he's got a bunch of books that he's still waiting on. So he's going to do that. And I thought, well, what better time to actually celebrate?
It sounds just like a false truth to a half outcome. You know, like, we're just going to say this thing because no one's really going to look deeper than the three big guys out there who have such huge campaigns that they can't even fulfill this year if they wanted to because they have so much stuff that they're offering in their tiers. But no one's going to be looking deeper than that, except, you know, we just did tonight.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
I don't know. I'm trying not to speculate, but the claim was made, so... here's the response. Captain Love, Rise of the Pirate King, Chapter 1. Drew, another great guy, really fun person to stream with. I see him sometimes in the chat. His books look great. And yeah, I think he's on now his third or fourth campaign. So he's fulfilled a number of times, and this was just one of them.
And this is a guy he's in it, man. You know, he wants to go to cons. He wants to, you know, ship out and talk about Captain Love, man.
I love Robert in here confirming, you know, all the ones. Like, he's like, yeah, I got that. That's really cool to see. Jim still has 5 from 29 outstanding. Yeah, some people have a few more.
In the first book, there's actually a great rim job scene. That's what I heard.
Well, I'm moving on then. Well done. Well done, Drew. Great job. And yeah, I don't know if he's got on this list twice, but I can't remember, because he's confused me with all the different chapters, and there's like the first one and then there's chapter 1 of Pirate King. But he's putting out the business, and we salute you, Drew Ish. I call him Drew Love. Got good songs too. All right. Cyborg USA by Rob Casey. So it looks like this finished up in late 2019, and I don't know exactly when it fulfilled, but I have been informed that it did. And yeah, we were talking about this book on that History of CG. This was sort of unintentionally became a controversial.
Infamous thing. Cane and White cover. Look at that.
Yeah.
Yeah. High energy. I remember the theme song sticks in your head. Pablo Romero art. Really cool. Andy could still get it. I have to pick one up.
Eddie got his in 2019.
Really?
Even though if this campaign ended in November 2019, that's pretty epic if that happened.
Is that true?
He's got a t-shirt and everything. So yeah, well done, Rob Casey. I still see him around a bit on Twitter.
I miss his cigars. You know, looks like
he's still in demand too, so he's got copies left if anyone wants to grab one up. You miss his cigars. Yeah, he sits there
huge
puffing on the cigars. Hammer of Doom says 2021 is the rise of the crowdfunded indie book. CG is dead. I don't know whether to take that seriously or sarcastically.
Crowdfunded indie book.
No, he's not being sarcastic.
Okay. All right.
No, he's just arguing with people in the chat.
All right. Graveyard. Did anyone back this little thing?
Unfortunately.
Yeah, I backed this. I got issue 1 and 2. Thoroughly enjoyed it.
You didn't learn your lesson with issue 1?
Learn my lesson with what?
Yeah. No, I'm kidding.
Well, I mean, what sold it on me is the puffy nipple. You know, you're like, hey, I want to draw a butt shot and a puffy nipple in the same thing. You're like, well, you just got to have her twisting it out. I mean, she's flexible, and there you go. It all worked. This was obviously a massive success.
Oh, $230,000.
The lumbar spine doesn't work that way, but the thoracic does. So
It's all right. She's undead. So whatever happens. Me
an extra supplemental book and U.S. Assassin.
Like Model V is accusing John of ripping off Cecil's graveyard gang. Well, look, you know, these ideas, they're in the air. You just, it's about who's first to market.
You got to jump on them.
Oh, yeah, the golden ticket. I forgot about that. I'm a bit upset I didn't get one either.
Yeah, I didn't get one either, and I still haven't heard what the what you got to redeem that for.
I think Malin just made it up. No one got a golden ticket.
Can you imagine? Yeah. Billy's pissed he didn't get one as well. Oh, no, you missed Graveyard Shift 3. Yeah, that's the thing about Malin's campaigns. You got to get it on the...
Get it while it's hot.
Get it while it's hot. Exactly. Does anyone know off the top of their head what Volume 3 raised?
I don't remember.
$250,000, $260,000 or something, maybe.
The cool thing we also have to remember about these campaigns is he's doing these supplemental books, which allows outside, you know, artists from their crew, usually artists in CG, to get spots at writing these characters and drawing them. You know, one of my favorite stories from Graveyard Shift was actually the Kyle Jamison story from the supplemental book in this campaign.
Mm-hmm.
Very well written. Great art. It's really cool.
So I don't forget this. It's not really for this show, Frod, but yeah, this is a topic that I could probably get into a little bit. I do pre-press and everything like that. What makes this such a difficult, time-consuming thing once the book is done? It can. It depends on how it's set up, basically. Ooh. And what... You know, it's a really bad answer, but it depends. But I could definitely get into that if we do a topic on that on pre-press. You know, different colors print differently. So if your book is really blue-green like mine, it can be a headache. If it's other colors, it can't. It doesn't have to be. So anyway, just happens to be what it is. Zoom in on. We're zoomed in enough. Everyone has seen the puffy nipple long enough. We're gonna give out tip the hat to Mr. John Mallon and Mark Poulton, and move on to another small time creator, the Cyberfrog Unforgettable Tales. Just a paltry 4,000 backers, 300,000 raised on, I think they were $10 comic books. I still friggin' love
miss
this.
These.
This image here is my favorite.
That's cool.
Just bloody amazing. Obviously a massive campaign. Hey, this guy here looks a bit like the stump guy, like the big neck dude. But anyway, Jay Lee, this is the one that had the Jay Lee like preview. I think they only printed about 200 of them. Freaking amazing art.
Poster.
Everyone knows about this. It was a massive campaign. I think it's in the top three or, you know, definitely in the top five of books of 2020. But it ended in March 2020. And yeah, I got mine. Cyberfrog, who did that fulfill? It absolutely did. I've got it in my long box. I still haven't. There's another one I still haven't read. I've got a bunch. I got about 12 I still need to read.
And I think you can still grab them on eBay through his eBay store, right?
Always trying to start trouble with me. All right. Well done, Ethan Van Sciver. Another fulfillment. I think that's number
54,
three or four for campaigns he's fulfilled, and he's got another three going at the moment. Psycho 66 by Matthew Weldon. Another one I remember this campaign, but I don't remember much about it. I remember this cover here. But yeah, I don't know Matt Weldon.
Yeah, it's like a 60s Ultraman, giant monsters. Pretty cool. Matt Fowler is the writer on this.
Mm-hmm.
Put it together, and he's doing some pretty cool stuff with it as well.
Well, his pencils and inks as well.
Fowler?
Yeah. Oh, no. Oh, Weldon.
Yeah, Walden's doing
it. The Matthews are confusing me. Psycho 66 issue 2 is up live.
Oh.
There you go.
Okay.
Oh, sweet.
What are you doing there?
Camel Moon, what was that?
Camel Moon, what are you doing? Bagging and boarding?
Yeah, I mean, I'm just
like, hey, bring me on the show. I'm just going to like do stuff randomly in the background of you.
This isn't as an nerdrotic show. I keep
busy. I got a lot of shit to do.
Oh my God. All right. So yeah, well done. The people in the link told me that Psycho 66 fulfilled. So there you go.
Mortal V says Matthew loves his pregnant ladies.
Does he?
Who doesn't, man?
I mean, getting them pregnant is the fun part.
Well, yeah, that's
about having them pregnant.
That's the thing I don't want to deal with. You got to find them already.
Apparently, Brand has fulfilled as well. I don't have that on this list. I don't think if anyone wants to get
that. Can't confirm that.
Well, people are confirming it. People are saying they're getting it. I've got
the Brand copy. Well,
here's the thing. I hear a lot of people got Brand, but then a lot of people also have not gotten Brand.
I don't know then. I don't know. Do we talk about it? Maybe we flash it up on the screen for 5 seconds and go, maybe. Sucks if you didn't get it. I don't know. Pandemic.
Yeah, I heard this fulfilled. Yep. I heard someone did a review.
Yeah.
Was that you talking about that?
No, inch high.
Oh, I watched that.
Comics guy. I mean,
yeah.
Yeah.
He was
watching.
Furious.
Does he go through the story a little bit?
You know, well, he did a whole video on the first panel.
Oh my gosh.
Well, he really, his argument is that it starts in the second act.
Yeah.
I haven't read it, so I can't attest to it, but his argument was mostly that there's no first act, so there's not enough of a setup to care by the time you get to the second part of the story. Which,
like,
if true, yeah, I mean, if that's true, then that's legitimately a concern, you know? But I think all of his
critiques are pretty legitimate, even if I don't agree with them. I don't think he's like just out there to troll. He seems pretty genuine in what he's saying.
Oh yeah, no, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that, like, I can't sanction what he's saying because I just personally don't know. I haven't read it.
Okay.
Yeah, I was going through his review today, actually, and I don't have the book. I haven't read it, but yeah, it seems like one of his big problems with it was that it started, as they say, in media res, meaning it starts in the middle of the action, and mm-hmm. then you are supposed to kind of catch the reader up as it goes along, but he really didn't like the beginning, and then I don't remember ever hearing him get into the details of the story.
He did about really. Six videos on it, and four or five maybe. And I
didn't get all the way through them then.
Yeah. He starts mm-hmm. to get into it more, but I think it's like he's you know, he's spacing it out because he does seem to get kind of angry about it. It's pretty entertaining.
And when he found out that I have a copy and that I've read it, he's like, I can't wait to see what your review is. Because I was going to do a review of it. So I've been rereading it to try and find things to say. So it's worth 10 minutes. And yeah, okay, it's not great. I don't mind starting in the middle of an action scene. I said I was going to hold off on seeing his videos until I'd done my own. But to hear that he's doing a Mahler Spurgout over this book is just like, that's way too much. The book isn't good, but it's not worth that much. It's
like, no that, way. Yeah, there's things I don't agree with what he says on, and one of them is I don't know why he gets so angry about it. Like, he was like, I am fuming about it. Like, all right, it's a comic book, you know. But, you know, it is entertaining. So, at the very least, it's that.
It has pages? Okay.
There you go. Anyway, back to Pandemic. You know, he put it out. He said he's going to sell you a book. It got done. Renzo is one of my favorite artists. So, I mean, I got mm-hmm. nothing to say about the art. The book looks great. I didn't realize this book was in color. I mean, there's no color on this campaign. So I didn't realize it was actually a colored book. I probably would have backed it if it was.
Renzo and the coloring on it are really the good things about it. That's it.
Kimasabi says, you know, if you want shorter, more even-handed reviews, I know a guy. Everyone go sub to Kimasabi. He does reviews as well. That's the one thing I said, that I want to see more people doing more people doing reviews. Yeah, I like this as well. The anger was a comedy bit. I think so too. I thought it was quite amusing. So there you go. Well done. Well done, Richard Meyer, your boy Zach, for getting Pandemic into people's hands. Vestry number one was fulfilled by Greystone Press Comics. Now remind me, Blue, you know who does mm-hmm. Vestry, don't you?
Shabby and Pickles is the way I know them.
Okay.
Great name.
Shabby's the artist and writer and all that.
Again, another book I don't really know much about. I do actually remember this book, but I don't think I got too deeply into
it. I just remember the title.
Looking into it. That's
pretty cool.
Well, there you go. That's a title, a memorable title.
Maybe I'm thinking of Mark Silvestri.
Jacob. There you go. Jacob Sebesta. Yeah, another guy I think I may have ghosted. God, I'm terrible. I need to get back to people.
I have tried multiple times to get them on your stream. You ghost me when you ghost them.
I know.
He thinks he's big time now.
It's not that. I ghost my own mother. It's terrible.
No, Jacob doesn't think he's big time. He's really humble. But Mike, oh my God.
No, it's not that. It's not that, I swear. Akima Sabi's talking about Blood Hunt. Yeah, yeah. look, we'll get some people on. I didn't mean to click that, Rob. I wouldn't have clicked that. Like, it popped up. I was supposed to click the thing above it. Never heard of Vestry. Well, I think some people aren't getting out, onto all the streams, and that's because people don't respond to them when they ask, and that's me, and I apologize for that. But Mike, it is what it is.
I dropped a comment in the chat for you. You're welcome.
This one. Hello, Blue. What are you doing, Blue? Michael is getting big head and feet. My feet look normal, all right? Maybe there was a little bit of a shadow highlighting the veins in that.
I don't know. Your feet look like they should be on Liam,
No, they're normal feet. There's nothing wrong with them.
Those hobbit feet, man.
No. Okay, we're moving on. Well done, Greystone Press, Jacob and the team. Who'd you say, Shabby?
Yeah, that's his nickname online.
Dylan Clark. Pickles. Dylan Clark and Jacob. And Cassidy. So well done, guys, for filling. And I think Vestry 2 is a thing, so maybe we'll get him on for that. Tilt by Doc Hogg. That was a book that came out, and we've seen that Tilt 2 is that campaign is live. People got their tilt. I don't know much about what people thought about it. I don't know if I've seen any reviews or anything like that. But I mean, I dig the poker theme. I wanted to talk more poker with Doc, but he wasn't. People don't want to talk poker with me. I don't know why.
He's a poker man. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I thought, hey, we should. I want to get him
merging the two things started. He loves.
Exactly.
Yeah. The cool thing about
7 and 9 got his tilt.
There's a lot of. I wouldn't be surprised if 7 and 9 is in here, because there's a lot of get drawn in tiers where you can get killed. Like be mobsters and stuff.
It could be. He'll be able to tell us. He's right here. Who else? David Feed says, I got tilt and it was pretty fun. Well, there you go. It's about this woman. She can pull cards out, and then the people on the cards, so like the Jack of Hearts, will come to life or something, or the King of the King of Clubs, and kill gangsters for her. It's a it's pretty out there thing, but that's what you can do in comic books. What is Rob saying? He didn't want to talk to you with you in general. What is happening? Don't mock Bancroft or his feet. Remember, it was hobbits who destroyed him. If 7 and 9 doesn't die at least 5 times a year, he feels unfulfilled. All right. So, yeah, well done, Doc Hogg. Another friendly guy. I like him. He's a cool guy to hang out on a chat with. College of the Dead. Again, controversial. With this is the margins. The infamous margins.
Controversial?
The marginalized comic of 2020. The
marginalized comics of 2020, yeah.
I'd say he's got the biggest margins in CG.
And he's chosen again to have a woman in, I think it's the Mermaids book, getting her arm bitten off.
So maybe it's like a fetish of his.
It's a thing of his, I think.
Well, yeah, it's like an Adam Post thing. You know, Zade Comics has the velvety cover. Adam Post got the nugget women. You know,
bite a woman's arm off.
The nugget women.
Hammer of Dune points out 6 panels per page. Yeah, total bargain.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, look, I wasn't a huge fan of the panel layout thing, you know, it is what it is, and I really dig these covers though. This is really nice art, and you know, Adam Post has been around a while, helping people out, spruken books, getting on streams. He was doing his COMICSGATE, the Secrets of the COMICSGATE Network for a while, which I thought were really helpful for people looking to crowdfund. So yeah, well done, Adam Post. 556 backers. You know, one thing I remember about him actually fulfilling this was him being on streams and pulling that plastic cover off the sticky stuff on the bags. So you just be on a stream, you see this grrk, grrk every, you know, 20 seconds or so.
Jesus.
It's like, hey, I'm fulfilling, this is what we do. Well, I guess I can't argue with that.
There are times to mute.
I prefer the format of the first one where he had, you know, one or two panels on each page. I thought that actually worked.
Mm-hmm.
But you know,
it is kind of like reading storyboards, but at least they were bigger.
Yeah, know? Yeah, I didn't mind that actually. I thought it fit. Hammer of Doom's demanding 16 panels per page. All talk. Did you guys see that Tom King book that's been going on Twitter?
Yeah.
What if I gave you to that? What if I gave that to you, Joe, and said, "Hey, I'm thinking of doing this in the Lucent."
I'd get out my big red Sharpie and start slashing away at it.
good to hear. I just wanted to make sure I made the right decision.
Did you see that guy jump? I interacted with Literature Devil a little bit on that one, on the Tom King thing. Once people, because I'm blocked by Tom King, but did you see that guy who jumped in? Okay, we're all friends with each other essentially in a way. And some dude jumps in to start insulting us that we have no idea what we're talking about. Issue 5 was classic, blah, blah, blah. And it's like, he starts insulting us. Like, what the hell?
You know, they're idiots.
Yeah. It's just like, I finally figured out there's that mute person thing on Twitter. And just, you know. Oh
that's the best. That's the best way to do it. That way you just kind of, it's like you're Homer Simpson just going into the bush. You know, you don't have to upset anyone. And you just sort of slide out,
and then they can also make comments and they don't know that no one's reading them.
Well, okay, here, I'm sorry, I skipped a beat telling that I put my mouse over him before I muted him, and one of his things is he loves commenting on pop culture comics and screaming into the void. And it's like, well, I'll let you scream into the void all you want. Mute this kid.
Yeah. Done.
Some people need to do that.
Nicholas asks, there's not one website where you can go find everyone. I don't think there was IndieCron. And I'm pretty sure that's still going. I don't know if it keeps the ones up that have come out live. I don't know. There's a new one called comicsgate.org, but I think that's sort of still, you know, growing. Mm-hmm. Actually, Robert is in here who made that. You'd probably have to ask him if he's, you know, thinking of making some kind of archive.
By the way, Nicholas, your icon, your avatar there. Can we see Nicholas again?
Oh, yeah,
working with horses is a really cool thing, but I like how your horse is giving us all side eye in the picture.
So. Where is it? Where'd he go? Oh
my God. You lost him.
I've lost him now.
Oh,
I've lost him. He's around here somewhere.
It's not worth chasing down. I said it.
All right. And yeah, there was another one, Creator Go.
Yeah, creatorgo.com/CG. That's the CG tracker. So you could see all of the books that have come out this year and how well they did.
Yeah, so people are doing things. It might not be exactly what you're thinking of, but I mean, yeah, if you go onto all of them, you'll probably be able to find a good bunch. There you go. Robert is in. He's saying it does have closed campaigns too, but he's just started that, so it might be being what's that word I'm looking for?
Worked on.
Worked on, but like having things added to it, like to build up the existing under library.
Construction.
Anyway, moving on. Well done, Adam Post. Let's go. Sea Dog and Codename Killswitch by Mark Poulton.
Another one from Mark Poulton. He showed up 3 times already on this.
Mm-hmm. Damn. Well, he's a writer.
Ooh.
What's that supposed to mean?
It's not like he's
you
a
know
color.
Exactly what it means. It means he's just like, fulfilling books. Ding. Another one. Ding. Right, another one. And then he leans on the artist.
You're right. You're right. Screw Mark
Poulton.
You're right. Screw Mark Poulton.
Yeah, it's not like he's got a day job or a family, Phil.
No. That's definitely not. No. I joke, Mark. Well done. So, yeah, what's that? 3 times? We've seen Mark Poulton pop up. Well done. Fantastic.
And even if this was an older property that they finally got on, I don't care. They fulfilled it. And if I'm misremembering the property, I don't care. They fulfilled it. So I'm happy.
I think you are. Mm-hmm.
This is a cool looking book. I don't know. This I do remember it. I remember the name. It's quite memorable. I think I actually looked at it on one of the old COMICSGATE things that I used to do. I didn't back it, but it looks really good.
Yeah, so this is basically Mark and his son came up with a character named Sea Dog, who's a superhero. He's a rapping dog by day and then a superhero dog by night. And then the Clint Holinsky had a other team of characters that he was working on, and they basically put both of those IPs into one. Codenamed Killswitch is the team of superheroes, and then Sea Dog is like the big superhero guy that they have to work together.
There you go.
Do they adopt him?
Okay. Well done, Mark, for the triple crown.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's amazing. A Frager Dog by Day says what about.
True, yeah.
Here's a book that I've not heard anything about. I mean, it came out. It has a weird name. I know Ethan promoted it. I don't know how much Zach promoted it. I don't know anything about it. I know Kelsey Shannon was the artist, but he was asking Kelsey to just like do really fast lines. And I haven't heard anyone talk about it, but people are telling me it's been fulfilled.
Yeah, a mental patient during riots escapes an asylum, and no one notices.
How many pages is it?
Probably another 22.
22?
Unqualified 22? What the? Unqualified Comics. Your boy Zach fulfilled it. Can confirm, did a review on my channel. So if anyone wants to know what this book is about, I mean, Blue just gave us the premise and it sounds pretty kooky, but you know, it's your boy Zach. He can move in 2,000 backers. What do I know? Go check out Unqualified Comics to Unqualified. See what it's about.
Yeah, he just said it's 22 pages, just like Pandemic.
Wow.
There's supposed to be a trilogy, but you don't need all three. You just need one of those two and then the next one to come out, which is Theosophy. So,
okay. Snuggy Junior says, no, he's fine, better than Pandemic.
Ooh.
Look, I'll have to take your word for it. I didn't really pay too much attention to it. This is one of the one times that Richard interacted with me when I was like commenting in his streams. And I just left a comment saying, I'm sorry, I'm just like, if I'm going to buy a comic book, I want some kind of supernatural or fantastical or something going on in there. And he actually brought that up and said, well, that's fair enough. I can understand that. I was talking about not backing Iron Sights. Well done him. I mean, he's pumping out books.
22 pages, and has that success with it. That's amazing.
That's probably why I was able incredible. To come out so fast, too. You know?
Oh, Snuggy says the sequel has changed its title to be Yes. Instead.
and then the finale is Maybe.
Maybe.
No, yes, maybe. That would actually work. I like that.
Yes is the prequel. No is the what? And then maybe is the sequel.
Here we go. Overpriced. $15 to $10 is to 22 pages is too much. Yeah, it's...
Is it? I mean, that's just half of what a 48-page would be.
That's, I mean, look, I don't know. It to me, it depends on what's on there. And as much as I love Kelsey Shannon, you know, I remember him saying, like, he was just saying, like, really just give us the rough sketch. Like, do it really quickly. Anyway, I'm not going to say anything more, but...
I didn't think No was to my taste, but for the amount of actual story you get and depth of character, rather than just character establishment, the 22 pages for Pandemic was a joke.
Okay.
Yeah.
22 pages.
Jasper says, it was a performance art piece of sorts. I respect the Kelsey pages and spirit of the story. $15 for a book, $10 shipping, or $10 is shipping is kind of standard.
There you go.
Fraud 79.
No, do as you're told. Yes, clean your room, maybe. Be sure to drink your Ovaltine, your boy trilogy. I would like to see that happen. Oh my God, no. All right, moving on. Your boy Zach, another triple crowner, I think. In 2020, I think he did three. I think he fulfilled three. Mm-hmm. Although he does have some outstanding
that is three,
Expendables.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think he'd promised to fulfill Jawbreakers 3 this year anyway. But anyway, yeah, good job. Tip of the hat to Richard Meyer. One Pool, Journey of the One. Here's a book that has escaped my attention. And, I mean, it got a number of backers, 382 backers. It looks like a lot of fun. Who knows about this one?
Did you get this, Blue?
Got it. Haven't read it yet. Was glad he finally got out of the trouble he was in with his printer to get it printed and shipped from Canada. A lot of hassle on this one. This guy's a good example of people who tried to get into COMICSGATE. And I don't mean, you know, the money, you know, people coming along saying, oh, I smell money, I'm going to dive in like that. But actually earnest people who wanted to be part of COMICSGATE, but their name just didn't get big enough. And so they sort of did their thing and they're kind of going, I don't know about a number two or, you know, things like that. So we may or may not hear from that. I think we'll hear from this guy again. But there are actually a lot of COMICSGATE books like that that just weren't really well known. So if people say, hey, was that guy even COMICSGATE? Some of them were, you know, they just are sort of, they had to get a job.
Still got 382 backers, which is,
ooh, that's good.
Yeah, decent.
This was a very book decent. That I saw early on when I was coming into CG, this and guys like Jack Irons as well, that were kind of, I don't know, I felt like they were fringe, you know, hanging around.
Cody Fernandez is notoriously anti-label.
Anti-label?
Like doing his own thing. No, yeah. he's like, I'm doing my own thing. I'm doing Jack Lyons.
And I saw guys like that and like the Skunk Girl guys and Juan Pool kind of like in their own area. Then I never really heard about Juan Pool again. But yeah, it's good that it got fulfilled.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He had printer troubles and Indiegogo depositing into Canadian bank troubles, if that was him. I think that was him. But yeah, he was really earnest about wanting to get it fulfilled, so good guy.
Is this the guy that had lots of troubles with Indiegogo? This guy?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, now I remember. Yeah, I remember someone saying Indiegogo has been an absolute nightmare, because usually everyone's like Indiegogo is super, you know, smooth and easy and no problem. And this guy had a huge problem. And I remember thinking, well, why is it doing that when he's only in Canada? I mean, I'm in Australia and I had no issues. Mm-hmm. But okay, there you go. So that's what I remember him from.
And we got a green highlight from Mike. Sorry, the other Mike. There you go.
Is that Mike? Nine Realms Comics? Okay, I didn't put that together. I would have read that. So like, who is this guy? I can see him there now. Thank you for $5, man. He says, just dropping a line to say hi to Michael and his merry gang on the chat. Super glad to be part of this list. Yeah, well, congratulations, man. You put in the work. You get the rewards. You know, you're on the list and a lot of people aren't. So, you know, you earned that position.
Hey, Joe Ball. Have you guys seen the new statue on Mike's campaign for Elysium Fields Pyramid Gambit?
I have, yeah. I
saw that today.
Holy cow. Yeah,
I saw the tweet. Looks dope. Looks really good. Congratulations, Josh. This is the last one on my list. Now, Blue, still, I mean, we're nearly 2 hours in. So that definitely books have fulfilled this year. Case of the Littlest Umbrella is another one. A big one.
Big, yeah.
Big one that went out. So he funded this in 2019 and backers got it in 2020.
Yep. I enjoyed mine.
Anyone else? I didn't back this, so I can't say anything about it.
I got the second one. I'm waiting for the second one. I didn't get a chance to get this one.
It's I would say it's definitely one that, truly all ages, which is how mm-hmm. I'm doing my books. We're going to look to publish the first one in 2021, where it's basically, it's more written towards adults, but it's safe for kids to read. And so this is one where if you're a parent, you have young kids, you can sit down and read this with your kid and you'll both enjoy it.
Cool.
Excellent to hear. Well done, Tug. And we know he's got his second campaign, which was a massive, massive campaign. He broke 200,000 on that, didn't he? Or did he not? Anyway, he got a butt ton of backers. His channel's been going off. He's been telling stories about Amber Heard and Johnny Depp and everything. And
another case is sitting at 150 right now.
There you go. Pulling those numbers. Growth at least. The dude came out. He did the thing. He built up his audience. He fulfilled, and now he's doing it again. Brian says we need more kid-friendly books. Rob wants your spot, Camel Moon.
I like,
or at least he's saying you need to get off.
Okay.
don't like. We don't just do whatever Rob tells us to do.
No,
Robocopter.
Camel's like my security blanket. He can't leave.
All right.
I make everyone warm and fuzzy.
Well done. Well done, Tug. Thug. What do you got there, Blue? How many do you have? You said you had 30? My goodness.
Before, you've done some of them, thankfully, but now we're down to, I think, 22.
Okay, let's get into them.
Let's see them.
So, anyway,
I've got to share the screen, don't I?
Yeah, you're going to do. I warned Mike, by the way, that maybe he can come on later this week, maybe, but we can't ask you or you'll ignore us. So there's that. Hero. Where's my mouse? There's my mouse.
True Blood of Patriots.
Yeah, this fulfilled this year as well. It is a little bit older from when the campaign started a bit ago, and it ended in June of 2019, but it did fulfill. So that's Muttman and Macho Dan. It's, I think, before March. He said they're going to have their sign up for Hero 2 in end of February? Or sorry, end of December. Or, nice. In a month. Good enough. Sorry, Phil.
No. Yeah, these were two guys that were early in my, being around CG that had me on. Definitely were buddies and went hard at work working on this, and kind of took a back from the social media aspect because they were working on this so much. Awesome colorist on this as well, Eugene Bativu. He's the colorist that we use on Magikop and a bunch of stuff in the Lost Pages as well. So great work on this book.
Cool. Gunship Thunderpunch. I know that Brian Shearer is very friendly to people who are CG. He's not a jerk to anyone that I know of. Doesn't fly the flag himself that I'm aware of, but he's an earnest guy.
Yeah. Yep. He does his, he used to. I don't know if he still does. His pipe streams where he sits down and talks about the world with his pipe. A real pro.
I got the book. It looks good.
His animation is really good too.
Mm-hmm.
Really, Soul Finder fulfilled this. I think it fulfilled this year is when I got mine. 2020?
I don't remember.
I got mine 2020, so let's keep it on here. I really like this book. I like Doug, and I thought it was a fun story. It was really, really professionally made. It looks like a book you would buy on the shelf. From the printing, it's got that really excellent. I'm going to totally blank on the name.
Yeah. I hope, by the way, I hope that in the lobe of CG where Macho Dan and Muttman are, that maybe we can have them on sometime, because we should, meet up once in a while with other CG crowds that are around, just a little cross pollination.
Yeah, sure.
came in.
So Antoine is saying it did fulfill in 2019, which says to me, Doug, get your next one out, because then that'll be like 2 years. I mean, this is a good book. I want to see the next one.
The next one is in production, by the way.
Yeah. I've seen the cover looks amazing.
Door Kickers finally arrived, so I'm happy with that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is a book that I was always on the edge of, because I don't know, I really like the look of it, but I don't know, for some reason I just never jumped into the pool. Good job, Scott. Scott's everywhere. Scott's a bit of an unsung hero.
Door Kickers. It's on the to read list.
It's on a to read box. Anyway,
no, I've got the book. I just haven't been able to read it yet.
No, I mean, mine are all, I have a two-read box. It's ridiculous.
Oh, I gotcha. Anyway,
Merry Boys.
This is probably the most, like, I hear just amazing things from this.
It's again phenomenal.
And again and again and again. And I didn't grab it. I think I still can.
You, Mike, you would love it.
I'm going to do it. I keep saying that. I've got to do it.
It is one of my favorites. And you get... So this is another campaign where the creator wanted to essentially do the single issue format, but mm-hmm. also wanted to, and Carl Stefan, the writer, artist, he does everything. So he wanted the single issue format, but he also wanted to give you enough value for the price point. So mm-hmm. you get both issues. They're absolutely gorgeous. Any of the perks you get, high quality. It's just, can't say enough good things about the campaign or the creator. Carl's the man.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Everyone in the chat is raving about it as well.
Yeah.
I'm
sorry. Am I jumping too soon?
No. Go. You're good. You're much better than I am. With
Doc Salem, man.
This just arrived.
Monster Hunter.
Nice. Yeah.
In the last
week. I've been seeing the photos. Print came out great, looking good. Mm-hmm. Preston is another dude who's always seemed to be on the cusp of just hitting the big time.
Yeah,
hopefully it's going to come around this year.
He's a huge talent, and when you talk to him, you could just tell that he loves doing this, and he always wants to be doing this, and he is. Like every time you see him, he's drawn. And I feel like he's a guy that you throw a cool idea at him and he's like, hell yeah, let's do it. Like he's ready to do this stuff. And he breathes and sleeps it.
Yeah. This is, what's his name? Drawn Talk?
Yes.
Tyler.
Is that him?
Yeah.
I know it was. Yeah. We talked about this. Yeah. Tyler.
What's her name? Shay dragged him onto a stream to get into COMICSGATE, and he was really sheepish about everything. He's like, "I'm just going to make this campaign a week," and I'm like, "My wallet hates you." And so he could have had so many more backers if he had gone longer.
Long campaign.
Yeah, this was a week, and he got 44 backers. And he's like, "Okay, I'm done," because I forget what his deal was, but he wanted to be moving on to some other project. But yeah, it's fulfilled.
All right.
Anyway, Super Harem. It arrived. Ziplocs and all. I have what I do not understand people's problem with the Ziploc thing. It protected my book. So
Did you get a Ziploc, Phil?
I did. I may have thrown it away though.
Frankly, I would prefer the Ziploc. it's sort of part of the meme now. And yeah, I got no problem with it at all.
Well,
I received it in a Ziploc bag, I don't know.
He did zip it and then fold it over and then tape it, which is good because it has those. My bag had those hanger holes at the top, so it wasn't waterproof. But anyway, it was taped.
Good.
Kimasabi says Ziploc is love. Ziploc is life. Ziploc is love.
Oh, the other good thing Wenger did, he took all those extras, those little cards and whatnot, and put them in a little baggie like a drug dealer so the cards weren't scattering all around the box while it was in shipping.
Look at this monster. And
here's Phil showing off some of this Joe Ball art.
It's my boy, Joe Ball.
It's just insane.
Living the comic book life. Lots of detail in here. Yeah, Superhero delivered.
Nice.
Seven, he got his both covers in the Ziploc. Yeah, I think it was just a kind of a meme that ran away from us. And
yeah. And some people are still angry about it. So
we'll... people get angry.
Angry?
Here we go. Six Gun
Gorilla. Did we show this one yet?
No, we haven't. And I'm glad you got it because this is a favorite of mine this year.
Yep, loved this one.
I love how the gorilla has his own big oversized guns. Just
hand cannons.
The hand cannons.
Yeah,
it's a lot of fun. You know, and it's funny, you can tell, you know, Brian's hired different artists throughout the, I don't know how long he's been working on this project for. So as you read it in the graphic novel, you don't really notice. It just all feels seamless and together and great read. And I can't wait for what he's coming out next with.
This portrait really got me when he first added it.
Yeah, so cool. And I mean, like, Brian is a guy that's like a true indie guy. Like, he's been, of course, doing this for years, because when you get this book, you get the original graphic novel, and it's like, it's a shit ton of pages. The thing's super thick. But yeah, he's a true
indie guy. Costing Mo Biggs backers by promoting this instead of AR-15 orangutan. But we got to do it. He fulfilled on this year. I didn't see any AR-15 orangutans in my long box there.
True.
Yeah. Although Mel would prefer it. She's waiting for it. She's asking for it.
It's going to be every other year. Next comes AR-15 orangutan, and then we care about Brian again.
Steve used his Ziploc to put some weed in it. That's recycling. The man is thinking about the
Joe Ball would be proud.
He'll be back, Greg. Don't you worry about it. Although he's doing floppies from now on instead of the big book. I Borrow Ideas will be back at number one, Mo. Did you say? All right, what are we looking at now?
Okay, this came up actually on the chat stream with Leroy, who thank God went to bed. But I reminded him of this, and they were saying Sunsworn was the first CG novel. No, Legends of Phaustra, and it's already mm-hmm. fulfilled.
Yep.
And it has a bunch of CG people, or several CG people did artwork on it for the visual companion and whatnot, including Avery Butterworth, or Butterface, or whatever his name is. Avery.
Butterworth. Hail Avery.
Avery Butterworth. Butterface.
I like it. It'd be nice.
But yeah, Avery did art on this. He's the guy who's going to be coloring, what's it called? Hero with an E for Misfit Corner Comics.
Avery did a lot of colors for the Lost Pages. He also did a story for it as well, all illustrated and colored by him.
Thank you. That's the book. I must be nervous. Okay. Anyway, yeah, this is the first CG novel, and it's already fulfilled right there. So
I want to hear back some reviews on these books.
Yeah.
Like when people read them. It's obviously going to take a little bit longer, but Greg just asked, did they not promote it? They did a little bit, but yeah, it did.
I heard about that.
Yeah, it got some early promotion, but then when people found out it was mostly words, then they had a hard time getting publicity after that. Wouldn't, because there was a lot of other books coming out at the same time.
Mm-hmm. This was one of those examples of somebody who tried to get in with CG, but didn't get a lot of traction. And mm-hmm. so he finally started putting out, instead of a graphic novel, put out a set, is putting things out as floppies. His name's Ross Bamfield, as you can see. It's a book I think is actually going well. The first two were worthwhile. So he is fulfilled in 2020.
Before we move on from this book, can I just say to anyone, because I'm noticing, you know, this channel's growing a little bit. We've got, I think we probably had 75 people in here, but we're getting more people in here. So I'm noticing some new faces in here as well. And I see some of them have books. Like if you're in the chat and you're trying to, build your profile in this group of people, like come in here and have fun, hang out and talk shit and make fun of me and all that fun stuff. That is the way to kind of, make friends and meet people. And then later on, once people know who you are, you can mention you've got a book. That's the way to go. Like if you just come in here swinging with your book and links and everything like that, people aren't probably going to hit click them or, mm-hmm. or look you up if they don't know who you are. So yeah, just come in here, spend a month or two, not just in here, anywhere, any stream, and have fun, get to know us, and then we'll be a lot more.
And Ross Benfield had tried to jump into CG in late 2018 is when he started in. So he's not around to join our chat and have fun. He's, raising his kids and whatnot. So, but anyway, he fulfilled. Canadian Shield fulfilled real recently. So mm-hmm. This is the book that where the buckler comes from as a spinoff. Oh,
yeah. Geez,
the wrong window. Reading? So he fulfilled, which is good. This book is mostly just a character introduction with narration, but I think he's going other places with it. So there's that. And Chaotic Flux fulfilled number two. Actually, I think he fulfilled number one in 2020, but that might have been 2019. So he fulfilled. He's got number three coming up already. You guys have never heard of these books, have you?
No, I've heard of Chaotic Flux and the Canadian Shield.
Jeez, ask and you shall receive, huh? I tell them to come in and insult me, and they come in thick and fast.
King Crow, what's up, brother?
King Crow, sharpen yourself up on Mo Biggs a little bit.
Yeah.
Felix Haas has the link to the buckler, which is good. Golma, he's one of the, this is from Zach Bradley. He's one of the guys who hangs out in the Pontificators with Art Tiber. So he fulfilled, and that book is gorgeous.
Fully painted. Yeah, every page.
Like that.
Wow.
Yep. Very cool. I got this one. It's a gorgeous looking book.
Wow. Why did I miss this?
Yeah.
Golma sounds familiar, but I think this is the first time I'm seeing this.
Zach is one of those guys that doesn't like to promote himself.
Why are there so many people like that?
We were constantly trying to push him to do more promotion. But you can see on this page, one of the very cool things about his book is that instead of traditional panel borders and gutters, the panel transitions are invisible. So he had to compose all of the art with that in mind, but he still manages to guide your eye around the page and it works.
Very cool.
That is impressive. Very impressive. All right. So let's keep an eye out for this guy if he ever comes back and does another one.
Grab this one for his name just because he's, but he did fulfill this in 2020, even though this wasn't marketed to CG. Mm-hmm. But Steven has been putting books out, and here's one of them. So,
yep. Yeah, he fulfilled. Yeah, he's filled a bunch.
Yeah, I think I've got his other book down further in the line. We're almost there. Black Tiger joined CG, even though his book was printed already, and then he has fulfilled it. So,
hell yeah, John Hervey.
Yeah. He's got the other book out now. What is it?
His Magna, The Last Magna.
He's an example of a guy who, when he first came onto streams, he was like unsure of himself, and then the next time he came on, he just slid right in, having fun. It just goes to show, if you're not very natural at first, just keep at it. And
great creator.
He's a cool dude to hang out with, and the books he's producing are top quality. Antoine Dennison, thank you, my friend. $2. It's nice to see all these folks fulfilling books, man. It's great, and I'm so happy that we did this because this needs to be. People need to see this, and it's great to see people are seeing new campaigns and maybe finding some new creators that they didn't know about. I know I am.
Here's a little weird CG because there's another error on the stream with the chat the other night. Here's a little weird CG connection. Who was the first breakout Brazilian? And somebody said, "Oh, it's Stefani." My apologies, Stefani. It wasn't. Who's drawing John Harvey's other book, Magna?
Rod Looper.
And what did he draw before?
Detective Dead.
Yeah, and it's like everybody was drooling over Rod Looper, and nobody knew back then. I think it's kind of funny. Anyway, there we are. But so good for Rod that he's getting work now. That's fulfilled.
Trivia. A little bit of CG trivia there. Yeah. Tales from the Classroom. Rob, another guy I met this year. A really cool guy. God, I love his voice too. Listen to that all day. Yeah, it's a cool book. Cool book.
John Dillard's got a better voice.
Who?
John Dillard. Come on.
Yeah. Is this the guy who tried to help?
Huh? No, go on.
Is this the guy who tried to help with Stefani Renee in case
translation? He did help. Yeah.
He was the interpreter.
He came on a stream with Stefani. Stefani didn't need it, but I guess he needed a little push, a little nudge. Yeah. Stefani's English is fine.
Well, considering the time zone difference, that was a really nice favor that this Rob did for Stefani. So good guy. And let's see. Right window. This fulfilled. This little
down thing.
Yep. Enjoyed that one too.
Yeah, great writer. This guy does it well.
All right, another one I'm gonna have to back, because I'm just hearing nothing but good things about Downcast. So,
well, it's available now on Alterna Comics. If we can't get more big copies of it, but Mike, can't you get Alterna Comics in Australia? Oh,
no, we did. We were getting them, but now I think you just get them on Etsy now, can't you?
Okay.
Anyway,
this is not the one that fulfilled. This is the sequel, but number one fulfilled in 2020.
Okay.
Well, yeah. What a fun book, man. Battleman Knucklebomb. Super
one
fun.
Of the best titles ever conceived of.
Yeah, dude. And the storytelling panel to panel, he introduces you to a character and side characters and bad guys. It's awesome. I picked up off of his Etsy store after the campaign closed, which you could still get the first issue, I think, on his Etsy. And I just backed the second one because there's being big progression on it. I think he's shutting it down soon. Mm-hmm. But yeah, the guy's awesome. And he's really cool to work with. He did a story for Us in the Lost Pages, and he is a pro, man. He just oozes storytelling, this guy.
Comics Exposed, $5. What do you guys think of Richard Meyer getting choked up over a new DC comic? I don't know. I didn't hear that.
Did he get choked up? Oh no,
that's what he said in the video.
I didn't see it.
So I'll just briefly say, I did watch the video. I was shocked, and. He did confirm that he was sincere. It was not a bit. And so I asked, I posted a comment and I just said, serious question, Zach, what do you think is, because he said that, you know, Meg's got a lot better in writing. And so I said, okay, Zach, serious question. What do you think is a lot more probable, that somebody makes a major jump in skill from one book to the next, or that they were working with an editor who, you know, like actually held them to quality standards? Cause I've seen writers with a track record of, you know, what comes across as bad writing, and then they get a good editor who will actually edit them.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden it seems like they take a big jump in quality, and then they move on to another title with someone who's like an editor in name only. They're basically a glorified scheduler.
Yeah.
And the writer is just given free rein, and then it's, you know, kind of back to their old,
it's a good theory. Yeah.
The old standard. So I don't know.
Yeah, I think she'd let slip that she'd never worked with an editor, or at least they hadn't given any changes to the writing.
Right.
So, Doomsday Kingdom. Mm-hmm. I got this one confirmed, man. It's a great cover too. That blood splatter. Still, I didn't know I was getting that.
That was so cool.
This is a thick book too.
He splattered blood on it? What?
It's got, you can't really see it. Well, you can kind of see it. Isn't it like the red splatter? That's actually, it sits on top of the book and it's shiny.
It's like a spot UV.
It's a spot UV, but it's rays as well.
Yeah, so
it actually looks like it's been splattered on. Very post printing. It's a really cool effect. Haven't read it yet. I'm sorry. It is a long book, but I got a lot to get to. So came with a lot of cool prints as well.
Terra Olympus fulfilled. That's the other Stephen Koch book.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm from Australia. This is the correct current campaign for SOS, but we don't need to count him, so we don't want to overcount that.
Hail SOS, back that book.
I just want to show off Stump because it's actually a really, really good book. So don't forget about it. When the next one comes around, we'll see about, you know, begging him to reprint the first one. So there's that. And last but not least, the other Preston Acevedo.
Well, I think we do have to acknowledge
the other Preston. Yeah.
One other guy.
This is this fulfilled?
Yeah, I have a copy.
Yes.
Yeah, and I know that Brian Criscow is writing a new story for this series.
Mm-hmm.
With Preston as well.
It's good to see a few people double, even some of them triple dipping. Shit, did I miss a Moe Biggs joke? Zach's movie taste is having a blockbuster crossover event with his comic book taste. Ooh.
Yeah, the glowing review of Mags's book was hot on the heels of his glowing review of Wonder Woman 1984.
Yeah, well, that's what we have to keep
in
mind.
Did he really?
We have to keep in mind that Zach is, you know, his notoriety for loving bad movies.
Yeah.
That is true. That is true.
Anything without structure he likes. So,
David says for five Swiss bucks. Thank you, David. Zach has to praise five mag bucks as part of books, I presume, as part of an agreement with Wade, or so I heard. I don't know about that. Did we lose Camel? He just dropped out at some point.
Yeah, he dropped out.
Okay. I saw him yawning in there. I'm sorry to keep you up. There is a book. So well done again to our boy Preston, but there is another book we would be remiss to mention. He has been in the chat trying his trolling hard as he can. So we should probably bring this one up. But not least, Replicator Remastered. Did finish its funding in March 2020 and can confirm I have the books. I've got the prints up actually on the wall behind me. Yeah, really good books, top quality story. And we're all looking forward to the third one to be finished. We know the only person who's left working on it is Corey Barton. He's doing the colors. And yeah, and Rob's been calling me out. He's like saying, like, am I gonna crush you again in 2021, or are you gonna step up? And I'm like, well, I guess I'm gonna have to now beat the Rubblecopter.
By the way, Mike, I have one more tab to.
You got one Brutus. More.
There it is. Well, there's Brutus, but I have one more tab after to close on.
Let's have a look at Brutus because this is a long time coming, man.
Yeah, for sure.
I nearly backed it because of this cover alone. But it was at a time when I didn't have much money. But goodness, his cover.
Amazing. Yeah, I'm so glad that they made this a cover because then they reopened it and I was able to get a chance to back it. This was a book that I saw before I knew what CG was and before I really knew what crowdfunding comics was and really wanted this because I'm a huge freaking Lobo fan. And this book is so much fun. So if you're a Keith Giffen, Alan Grant, Bisley Lobo fan, you gotta get it.
Hail. Hello, hail, guys. Hail and well met. How are
we
doing
tonight? Long tonight, so you've managed to slip in at the tail end.
Sneak in right at the end here. And I thought since we're celebrating the greatness of COMICSGATE, it was apt to do so.
Yep. Did you say you had another book, Blue?
No, I had one more tab.
Oh, one more tab.
Good to close on.
All right, let's have a look.
How many tabs you doing tonight, Blue?
Just slipped one or two.
Hey, we got the headlines. You heard it here third, okay?
Uh-oh.
All horrible. Right, all right, okay.
Oh, dear. That sounds like the beginning of a Zach book.
It sounds like the beginning of a Zach book, which is always in the middle of the second act. So
you come in the meeting, you find yourself in a room like this. What do you do? Well, you steal the TV, of course.
Thank you.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, I hadn't planned on doing 2.5 hours, but I felt compelled to go through. And there's probably some we missed. I'm sure there are.
Oh, yeah.
Did anyone keep a tally?
I don't know. Maybe someone really.
He did at least seven. Because, I mean, it was a slim year for COMICSGATE 2020. Mm. Nobody seemed to be able to fulfill. So, I mean, you did like, what, six books maybe?
A few more.
There must have been more. Like 50, right? Because.
Oh, easy. 50.
We had 32, and then we did a pretty good chunk before.
We did a pretty good chunk.
Yeah. There was some overlap, but your point is still over. It had to be 60.
And the spread was big. There were big books, big campaigns in the $200,000 tier, and then small campaigns who made barely even a couple thousand dollars. So, just look, I'm happy that that's out there. Did we mention Vestige? Yeah, we didn't actually bring up Vestige, but Vestige gets mentioned as absolutely it fulfilled. I've got that. And Vestige 2 is printed.
Printed and they're sending them out like this week.
Just like Xenotype, it's there, it's printed, it's real, but I don't know if people have actually received it yet. So that's when I consider fulfilling when you start seeing the pictures.
Yeah. Liam hasn't sent the books out yet, so I would say he doesn't get to go on that list. But I would say Vestige 2 is right on the cusp. So they're sending him out this week.
I forget if Liam's deadline was February or March of 2021. If you read the campaign, it might say in there. But we forgot to show. Okay, yes, I was on Twitter starting last January, and Flying Fortress arrived after. So we forgot to show Flying Fortress. So Eric Weathers.
There you go. So there are others out there that we forgot to get to. And they're not snubs. We just, look, I had my Twitter thread and I was just clicking books. That's all I did. That was the extent of my research for the show. So thank you to everyone who replied to that thread with links to all the books that are fulfilled. And thank you, Blue, for finding more as well, because
we have a new guy. I mean out with the old, in with the new. NTM, which looks to me like it's from the Wizard of Oz, NTM. Anyway, that comics we were talking about, he has a campaign. I looked at it earlier today and whatnot, a couple weeks ago and whatnot. So I'd been posting the link early in the stream. I can post it one more time, but yeah, there's a new guy. He says he's a 15-year-old. I don't know, or the story was from when he was 15. It looks like he's just starting out his attempt at comics.
And he's 15.
He's 15?
Can confirm.
If you're not a fan of good comics. And he's been getting the Mo Biggs treatment.
Nice.
Thank you, Mo.
All day. There you go. Hang on.
I got
Vestige. Vestige 1.
There it is.
Was signed, sealed, and delivered this year.
Fun book.
Really cool. I got my copy right here, too.
Excited for the second one?
Yeah, they really got a cool story going on.
Yeah, that dragon cover on the second one is
Andrew Huerta. Oh my gosh, that guy
pretty
is
phenomenal. I give him that. That's
it. It's unfortunate all the shit that came his way because of people wanting to be a part of drama, and because we need more. We need more of Andrew Huerta. We need more of his stuff in COMICSGATE for certain. So
that's okay, Seven. I saw it. We did mention Johnny Phantasm, King Crow. Yeah, totally Bandito. I mean, look, yeah, that's me. I'm like, hey, let's just drop the drama and start putting out books. And I'm really happy that we did this. We got to see, I don't know the exact number, but I think it was a shit ton. Mm-hmm. A shit ton of books got into people's hands. It's fantastic to see. We saw the list. We went through the list in the late last week or whatever. It was a huge list of campaigns that were funded, and I mean it feels like probably at least 60 or so fulfilled. So hopefully that will continue to grow in 2021. I know I've got plans. I know a lot of people in here in the chat have plans. People here on the panel. Yeah. Have plans. Onwards and upwards. It's good shit. I'm really excited. Good stuff. Thank you guys for hanging out and doing this with me today.
Of course. I never flake on you, Bancroft.
You never do. I will never call you Flaky Diaz. You are head and shoulders. You're double dip Diaz, fulfilled Diaz,
and not a grifter Diaz. Either.
Like no grifting, people. No flaking, no mooching. The real deal. And a good 2 feet taller than me. So, I mean, what am I going to do? I got to bring you on. Thank you, Phil, for jumping on. Thank you, Camel Moon, for coming on and bagging your comic books in the background. Everyone,
I overheard really that. That's, no, he's a busy guy. He's a busy guy. Anyone who hasn't gone and seen the new Hail Salad, definitely go make sure you take a look at that. And you know, we want to keep him busy because he's got plans for 2021 as well that are not Hail Salad. Some of the books that he's looking to put out are going to be amazing.
Yes, he's a real talent. Hail Salad is just the beginning.
Yeah.
Thank you, Joe. I dig in the get up. Thank you, Blue, as well, especially for organizing all those links. That was pretty good. Oh, Frankie is giving me props for my pronunciation of Vinny's name. Yeah, Italian.
Hey, Frankie.
I don't know why I didn't think, you know, of these guys' names. Like, these guys sound like, you know, mobsters, their names. And the first time I read them in full was when I read their book. So, yeah, it was good to see. Thank you, Bandito, for jumping on as well.
Yeah, it's great to hang out with you guys. I wish I could be here more. I really do.
We wish it as well. And, you know, we wish it as well.
I do get to hang out in the sexiest chat in Comicsgate, though, from time to time. So that's always good.
I see you in there. And speaking of that, the sexiest chat, I mean, you guys have been going crazy from 2 hours before the show even starts. If anyone isn't aware, you're in the chat right now. The Bogan Discord, the chat starts usually a good 2 hours before the show starts. So if you want to come in, talk shit, have a party, it starts up, get in there, get in on the fun and enjoy yourself. It's there for you. We do that. I do that for you. And yeah, so how are you guys? The sexiest chat in all of CG. What's today? I don't know if I'll be able to stream tomorrow. I may be able to, but I'll let you know because tomorrow is New Year, so I might be out.
And here's to Comicsgate. Great job.
Fantastic job, CG.
So, and 2021 is going to be better.
Are you going to go back to that complainy thread that you were in, Mike, and give them a link to this video before they, you know, before they block you?
No. Okay. I don't do that. I hope that it will get back to whoever needs to see it, to see that yes, CG did fulfill a ton of books this year. All right, guys, we will. Yes, Passion. I will say hello to Frodo. I just got to go and do his hobbit hole. We'll see you next time. All right,
happy New Year's, everybody. Bye.